Lieutenant Governor Corrine Wood. As governor, I'll make our state live within your means.
What doctors fear and what you should know. Germ Warfare, Monday at 10.
CBS Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the National Football League.
Soldier Field in Chicago, where the NFC Central leading Chicago Bears host the Cleveland Browns. The Browns, sparked by a blossoming star and third-year quarterback Tim Couch, he'll face a hungry Bear defense led by Brian Urlacher. Next.
Subway presents Fresh Starts, a salute to the game's early season surprises. Subway, eat fresh. In Week 7, quarterback Doug Flutie earned revenge against his old team, the Buffalo Bills, scoring on a run with just over a minute remaining, giving the Chargers a 27-24 win. On the first play in overtime, Bears safety Mike Brown intercepted quarterback Jeff Garcia's pass, returning it for a touchdown in a 37-31 win over the 49ers.
When it comes to food, a lot of places have silly ideas to bring you in. But once you get to the taste, where's the fresh? Hey, Clucky, want something made fresh? Come on.
Try one of the new Subway Selects made on fresh-baked gourmet bread. Susie?
Great, Tim. Subway's got four new Subway Selects, like the delicious horseradish steak and cheese, all on fresh-baked gourmet bread and all made fresh right in front of you.
Whoa, check out that check. Subway. Just kidding.
You're looking at Chicago head coach Dick Geron. The Bears riding a five-game winning streak, and they are 5-1 atop the NFC Central Division. On the other side of the field, Butch Davis in his first year as the head man of the Cleveland Browns, and the Browns are at 4-2, and with a victory today can tie Pittsburgh atop the AFC Central. Greg Gumbel, Phil Simms, Armin Katayan on the shores of Lake Michigan. Welcome as the Browns tee it up. The Bears have won the toss, and they will get the football first. Autry Denson and Leon Johnson deep, and there's Phil Dawson set to kick it away as we get set for doubleheader football here on CBS. We're glad you've joined us. We're anticipating a good one. Two up-and-coming teams in the National Football League. From the one-yard line, it's Autry Denson. To the 20. 35, and out of bounds just shy of the 40-yard line, and a fine return to get the Bears some terrific field position. 37 yards on the return, and there is Shane Matthews getting the start today. Starting quarterback Jim Miller with the hip pointer did not recover this week as expected, and so Shane Matthews gets the call, and he was terrific in relief last week.
He was, Greg. He started the season against the Baltimore Ravens. He got hurt his ribs, missed 3 weeks of practice time, comes in last week cold, runs the offense very efficient, threw the football very well.
On first down, the handoff straight ahead. Anthony Thomas. And here's the offensive line.
The offensive line of the Bears, it's only given up 2 sacks this year. They are terrific.
In the backfield with Shane Matthews, Anthony Thomas and Damon Shelton. Dez White and Marty Booker are the wide receivers. And Fred Baxter is the tight end. 2-yard pickup on the play. It's a 2nd and 8. 5 wide receivers. As you look at offensive coordinator John Shue. Loose football picked up by the Browns. Number 92 is Courtney Brown, and in his first start of the season, Courtney Brown scores a touchdown.
The Bears spread the field. Number 90, let's who makes the hit. But Courtney Brown, making his first play after being out for the year, comes in. What a way to start for him.
Butch Davis on the sideline leading the cheers. Middle linebacker Wally Rayner gets just the 3rd sack allowed by the Chicago Bears this season. Courtney Brown returns for the touchdown, and the point after is good. Well, that didn't take long. less than 1 minute into the game, Courtney Brown scores the touchdown.
Well, the Bears spread their offense out, and what they were hoping that they thought they would probably see a zone defense. The Cleveland Browns become aggressive. They come after the quarterback. Shane Matthews not expecting to get hit that quick, of course. And Courtney Brown does a good job of picking up the fumble.
This is Courtney Brown's first appearance of the season. He strained a right knee ligament in preseason. The PCL, the posterior cruciate ligament. 33 career sacks, a Penn State record, and Courtney Brown, the number one pick overall.
The thing that was impressive for the Cleveland Browns, the Chicago Bears go with the five wide receiver look, and when they do it, no confusion on the Cleveland Browns defense. They adjust to it immediately, come with the blitz, hit the quarterback, and get 7 points. You know, usually, Greg, in that quick in a game, second play, you're trying to catch the defense off guard. In fact, it was the opposite.
So 55 seconds into the game, the Cleveland Browns grab a 7-0 lead. And this would be Denson again, this time from the 11. Tries the outside, and not bad return once again by Autry Denson. 23 yards, and Anthony Denman makes the stop. So once again, the Chicago Bears on offense. And we welcome those of you who watched Indianapolis defeat the Buffalo Bills by a score of 30-14. Less than a minute into the game, Courtney Brown picked up a Shane Matthews fumble and returned it for a touchdown. The Browns are on top 7-0, and here is Thomas. Those of you just joining us, here's the play. Wally Rayner in on Matthews, forces the fumble, and number 92, Courtney Brown, who has missed all of the action so far this season with a bad knee, makes a smashing return to the lineup.
Oh, gosh. I mean, you don't even dream those scenarios. We talked to Courtney Brown yesterday, very anxious to play, nervous about seeing his first live action. What a way to start.
Quick pass and overthrowing his intended receiver, Marty Booker, to Shane Matthews. A look at the Cleveland starting lineup. There's Courtney Brown on the right side. McKenzie's the other end. Gerard Warren and Orpheus Roy, some very physical defensive tackles.
And the linebackers for the Browns, Jameer Miller, is having a terrific year.
In the secondary, on the corners, Dalen McCutcheon and Corey Fuller, Percy Ellsworth and Earl Little are the safeties. There's Foge Fazio, the defensive coordinator for the Cleveland Browns. He looks on as his Browns look at the Bears at a second and 10, or third and three, excuse me. Matthews, quick screen this side. Thomas with running room. First down and more. Out of bounds at about the 40-yard line of the Browns.
The Bears do a tremendous job. They get all the receivers to the right that time. The quarterback drops back. You're thinking short pass. It's going to the right side. No, it's a screen to the left. And when you see plays like this, we had a chance to talk to John Shoup, the offensive coordinator. That is one of the reasons why the Bears quarterback only gets sacked. He's only been sacked 3 times this year, because they're diversified, do a lot of different plays on offense.
Gives to Thomas, and Thomas is hit at about the line of scrimmage by Earl Little, coming up from the safety position. After he picks up 2, it'll be 2nd and 8. And as you mentioned, talking with John Shoup, to say he's intense would be understating it a little bit.
Well, he has a good personality, Greg. We could tell, and I could tell by talking to him, when he stands up in front of that offense and addresses the team, they're going to pay attention to what he has to say.
Matthews has a tip at the line of scrimmage. It is intercepted. Intercepted by Earl Little. Two big turnovers now for the Cleveland Browns. Two turnovers in 2:05. Gerard Warren got the tip.
Dad, Timmy hit a home run.
Great.
Put the little slugger on.
Hello?
I hear you got a big hit today, Timmy.
I sure did, Grampy.
I won the game.
Sure wish I could have been there.
I did too.
Because that's what it said on my birthday and at Christmas when my baby sister was born and on Halloween.
There's a different way to look at your money.
What's it say?
ING. It's not an ending. It's a beginning.
Hey, it's Dark Mountain Roast Coffee.
Real robust, full-body coffee.
Always fresh.
As good or better than any coffee house.
And it costs less.
Dark Mountain Roast Coffee, only at 7-Eleven.
Get it while it's hot.
It's always hot.
Yeah.
Oh, thank heaven.
Change for a dollar.
Sure.
Introducing the all-new Chevy Avalanche. The only vehicle that changes from an SUV to a pickup.
Thanks.
Chevy Avalanche. Like a rock.
Even if you've watched...
Every alliance will be shattered.
Oh, my God.
The survivors thought they knew the game, but the game has changed forever. Don't miss the first 15 minutes of an all-new Survivor, CBS Thursday.
The Cleveland Browns come in with the most picks in the NFL, and they get one right off the bat here. And right away, the Browns spread the field on offense. Couch to throw. Has time across the middle, in and out of the hands of his intended receiver, Quincy Morgan. So Tim Couch will look at second and 10, and there is the third-year quarterback out of Kentucky.
Well, I think the thing that's helped Tim Couch so much this year, a change in the offense for the Cleveland Browns. Bruce Arians comes from the Indianapolis Colts, the new offensive coordinator, has an offense that suits Tim Couch, throwing the ball short underneath, and when they go play action, that's when they go down the field looking for the big play.
On second and 10, pass this side, and that's complete to James Jackson out of the backfield. Out of bounds just across the 35-yard line.
You look at the Cleveland offensive line, the problem they have so far, they've got to protect the quarterback better.
In the backfield with Couch, James Jackson and Mike Sellers, Kevin Johnson and Dennis Northcutt are the wide receivers, and the tight end is O.J. Santiago. Here's Bruce Arians. His son Jake, place kicker for the Buffalo Bills. The Browns have not excelled in this department the last couple of weeks. They get one here. That's complete to 85. Kevin Johnson and Johnson across midfield and into Chicago territory.
Now the Chicago Bears defense, it's pretty simple on first and second down, but on third down is where they get very inventive. Tough for offenses, and Cleveland struggles so much on third down, but this time they pick up the blitz. And you see Kevin Johnson, nice move at the line of scrimmage, a little hesitation, gets separation from the defensive back, and it makes it an easy throw for the quarterback.
On first down. And James Jackson gets maybe a yard or two. Two, we'll call it second and eight. Ted Washington with the stop. Speaking of that Chicago defense, the big change for them this year, the two big guys in the middle, Keith Traylor and Ted Washington, about 600 and some pounds worth of tackles right there.
Yeah, I'd say you're understating it. The linebackers, Brian Urlacher, he is terrific, and so are the two outside linebackers.
In the secondary, McQuarters and Wald Harris at the corners. Mike Brown made the game-winning return of an interception, and there's the man who runs the defense, Greg Blush. Give this one to Jackson, and Jackson tries the left side, comes up short of the 40-yard line. R.W. McQuarters coming up to help with the tackle along with Philip Daniels.
Now the Cleveland Browns, they're coming off their bye week last week, and we asked Butch Davis last night, well, coach, what'd you do during your bye week? What'd you do with the team? He goes, you know, we're not very good, so we just work on everything. And we didn't work on the Chicago Bears. They went out in pads. They did some hitting each day. He runs at what... In NFL standards, very physical practices, worked on the running game, and worked on third down conversions.
Couch from the shotgun on third and three. Jamel White is in as a wide receiver, flanked to the near side of the screen. Couch with time, throws, incomplete, batted down before it got to his intended receiver. Mike Green, number 43, made the play.
Well, it's interesting. We talked about Chicago Bears defense, very complicated on third down. Hey, they don't get it the first time, so this time, three down linemen, extra people to cover the wide receivers. Nobody's open, and Tim Couch is lucky it's not intercepted.
Leon Johnson, the former New York Jet, stands back at his own 10-yard line for the kick from Chris Gardocki. Fair catch is called for and made right at the 10-yard line. 31-yard punt and no return, and the Browns with a 7-0 lead.
Hey, you want to switch?
Sure.
Introducing the all-new Chevy Avalanche. The only vehicle that switches from an SUV to a pickup.
Good idea.
Chevy Avalanche. Like a rock.
Change the face of digital photography with the Intel Pentium 4 processor, the center of your digital world.
It's the new Ultimate Lover's Pizzas from Pizza Hut. Now with six kinds of luscious cheese and six kinds of seriously satisfying meat toppings. Or five garden veggies. Or two layers of zesty pepperoni. Just $8.99. The new Ultimate Lover's Pizzas, only from Pizza Hut.
Now through Saturday at Zales, save up to 50% and more on beautiful diamond jewelry. Like this 5-carat diamond bracelet, now just $4.99. Zales, the diamond store.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Southwest Airlines, proud sponsor of the NFL and official airline of Super Bowl 36. Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. And by Nextel, how business gets done.
About another month or so, there'll be small chunks of ice floating in the Chicago River, but now extraordinary weather for the first weekend in November here in Chicago. The Bears with first down at their own 10-yard line. 9:23 to play here in the first quarter. Anthony Thomas and Damon Shelton line up behind Matthews. Here's Thomas. And he spins for about 2 or 3 yards. And let's check in with Armin Katayan. Armin.
Thanks, Greg. You can certainly say that Butch Davis has a touch when it comes to transforming teams. He did it in high school in Oklahoma. He did it in Dallas. He did it in Miami. And certainly here with Cleveland. He said it all begins with one thing. That's consistency, which leads to a vision. That vision, he says, builds confidence in a team. Better practice habits, self-esteem, devotion. With Butch Davis, he said, attitude is everything. Back to you.
Boy, we can vouch for the fact he brings a great attitude to this Cleveland Browns team.
He's got a little presence, doesn't he, when he walks into a room, the way he handles himself. Of course, he's a big man, too. That helps.
On second and seven, Anthony Thomas getting a lot of work early on, cuts it upfield, and appears to have fought for enough for a first down. Percy Ellsworth, Anthony Henry make the stop, and we make our first visit to Jim Nance in New York. Jim.
All right, Greg, you know your partner knew how critical this game was today for the Giants. They were down 24-7 at halftime, on to overtime, and Morton Anderson, yes, from 42 yards. The Giants come back to win it, 27-24. Back to Greg and Phil.
Boy, you cannot underestimate the accuracy of a field goal kicker. I think Bill Cowher would probably vouch for that today, wouldn't he?
Does he still have one? No. Four missed field goals by the
Thomas again. And Thomas has wrestled down behind the line of scrimmage. That is the seventh touch for Thomas on the 10th offensive play of the day for the Chicago Bears.
Well, Greg, you said it. This, when you look at the Browns defense, they're 20th in the league against the rush. The one thing they do in pass defense, Butch Davis said, look, I don't have any stars in the defensive backfield, but, man, we're getting some interceptions. And we saw that. They got their 14th interception of the year already against Shane Matthews.
Now the Bears spread the field. Four wide receivers, second and 11. And now Matthews moves up under center. Quick drop. Throws this way. Has it complete to Dez White. And White out of bounds. Across the 25 to about the 27 or 28 yard line. Anthony Henry ran him out of bounds.
Well, the one thing I think this Bears offense it does have, it has some playmakers. They have the running back in Anthony Thomas. But Dez White, when you watch him run routes and catch the football, he is fast, quick, and you got to be careful because he's one of those receivers, catch that short pass, and he can make a big play out of it.
Third and three, and the Bears need the 30-yard line for a first down. Matthews throws it this way, complete, and reaching for the first down is Anthony Thomas. The question is, did he get there? Anthony Henry coming up to make yet another hit. He does have enough for the first down.
That play really illustrates why it's so hard to sack the Chicago Bears quarterback. Shane Matthews looked to his right and immediately turns to his left, finds Anthony Thomas coming out of the backfield. Nice tackle by Henry, but still just enough for the first down.
Mike Shook told us what they like to do early is slow down the pass rush by throwing little screens early on. He didn't throw one early enough to stop Courtney Brown and Wally Rayner. First down Bears. Matthews, incomplete. That pass intended for Marty Booker and Wally Rayner, who got a game ball from Butch Davis for his play the last time the Browns took the field and beat the Baltimore Ravens.
That's what I was going to say, Greg. Watch Wally Rayner, number 58. Nice read. Sees the receiver coming across, looks at the quarterback, and makes a nice hit against Marty Booker. And I thought maybe Wally Rayner, he might be the weak link of these linebackers for the Browns, but the last 2 weeks, playing very well.
Second and 10. Thomas leading his way to the 35-yard line. And a little pushing and shoving between Brockermeyer and his opposite number on the Cleveland Browns.
Well, we had a chance to talk to Anthony Thomas on Friday, and enjoyable, the rookie, and it was interesting to him. I said, what did you expect when you came in the National Football League? He goes, well, I thought I'd come in, try to fit myself into the team, and maybe late in the year, I'd get some runs, get a little bit of action at the running back position. No, this is not college, Anthony. This is the pros. They throw you in there right away, especially when you're a high draft pick.
Thomas with 50 total yards so far today. Quick pass over the middle, and that's complete to Fred Baxter, the tight end. And that's enough for another Bears first down. 6-yard pickup on the play. Now, Fred Baxter is a guy seen last week in the victory over San Francisco having words with John Shoup on the sideline. And John Shoup said, you know, I like players to come and give me their opinion. And as a matter of fact, Fred Baxter made a couple of big catches down the stretch and in overtime.
Yeah, but he also said to us, there's some of them I listen to and some of them I don't, because there's a group of them don't know what they're talking about. They're always open.
Matthews. Rolling this way, looks, throws, overthrows everybody, and a penalty marker is down.
Well, the one thing I have noticed now, it's the third time Shane Matthews holding on the defense.
Holding, 78 defense, 5 yards, automatic first down.
Penalty is on Tyrone Rogers, defensive end.
Well, he was holding Fred Baxter, who was trying to sneak out for the short pass after the play action fake. But Shane Matthews, what I was going to say, three times now he's thrown the football and it slipped out of his hand where it got away from him. Yeah, I'd say that's a hold. Have to go to the sideline and have somebody stitch up your jersey. But look at that. You can see it gets away from him. Ball goes high almost always when it gets out of a quarterback's hands. Throwing into a little breeze, and that's always a factor too, especially early in the game for a quarterback.
First down, Bears, the pitch to Thomas. Thomas trying the right side. There's another marker down as he gets to midfield. And this is going to be against the Bears.
There's a flag on the play. Preliminary single, holding against the Bears.
Gerald Austin.
Holding, 83 offense, 10 yards, repeat first down.
That's the rookie, David Terrell, guilty of the hold.
You know, we watch tapes of games, Greg, getting ready for to do games on Sunday, and you watch film, but my first reaction is when I'm looking at this Cleveland Brown defense is it's fast, and they go after the football hard. Just like you said, the coach, he believes in being aggressive, Butch Davis. I know Foz Fazio does too, but you can see it in the players. They know their assignments, and they're very aggressive trying to carry him out.
Backs the Bears up to their own 37-yard line. It's first and 20. Matthews play fake. Throws out here to the side, and Thomas had it and dropped it.
Very seldom do you see an NFL player drop the football when they're really looking it in. They always drop it because they're trying to decide where am I going to run once I catch it. And watch Anthony Thomas. Look at his head. Oh,
actually,
yes.
He was looking up and down a little bit.
What, do you think I was lying?
Well, no.
You know, you got to trust me. I know these things.
Second and 20. Thomas wrapped up that time by Orpheus Roy, number 99. You know, it's funny as I sit back and think about what Butch Davis was telling us about Courtney Brown. He was saying, you know, it's his first game, it's his first action. We really don't expect too much of him.
Yeah, okay. Well, how about a touchdown? Did you expect that from your defensive end? And Courtney Brown, as you look at him, Jameer Miller has a nickname for him. It's called the Machine because he is so physically gifted, can run, he's strong, agile. He is a difference maker on a defense.
Third and 19, Matthews out of the shotgun. Has all kinds of time, throws over the middle, and it's intercepted. Brant Boyer, number 52, picks himself up and returns to about the 42 or 43-yard line of the Bears. Second interception for the interception-happy Cleveland Browns.
On a routine reconnaissance mission, Lieutenant Chris Burnett saw something no one was supposed to see. On November 30th, behind the courage.
They killed my pilot. Can we get him?
Behind the honor.
You're not going to let that kid die out there.
You will lose your command for this.
So be it.
Owen Wilson. Gene Hackman.
Gentlemen, I intend to put you in harm's way.
The truth lies.
We will bring you home.
Behind enemy lines. Rated PG-13. November 30th. Only in theaters.
What would you do if someone passed you the keys to a Pontiac Grand Am for a week?
Now I'm getting psyched.
I can't believe I did it.
Oh, my God.
Good boy.
How do you feel?
So excited.
Got it, Grammy. State number 3, right? I'm telling everybody for the rest of my life about this.
So what would you do with a Pontiac Grand Am? Tell us at Pontiac.com.
This is Will Burns. You've reached my cell phone. Leave me a message, and I'll call you back.
Will, it's Gail. I can't believe you're not answering your phone. Look, get back here. The client changed their mind. They actually like the work. All we have to do is show the plans to one more group and the job is ours. Call me before it's too late.
With ordinary cell phones, you leave messages. But with Nextel Direct Connect, the digital two-way radio, you get right through.
Attorney Nick Fallon once got busted for drugs. Now, he'll be tempted to make a tragic mistake. All new Guardian, CBS Tuesday.
From across the nation, young people gather to share their one shining moment, the NCAA basketball championship on CBS Sports.
Welcome back to Soldier Field, everyone. As we led up to this game, we were talking about such a throwback to old-time football with two longtime franchises in the NFL, and the Cleveland Browns are showing what defense is all about. Their second interception of the day and their 15th on the season. It's been defense for them.
Well, it has, and any time a defense is making interceptions, it usually comes because you're getting pressure on the quarterback, making him throw it before he's ready. He doesn't quite, he's not sure what he sees down the field, and the Browns have potentially two guys, Gerard Warren and the defensive end, Courtney Brown, two guys that can really rush the passer.
Meanwhile, down on the field, the injury that occurred to Keith McKenzie just before or on the final, the last play, he's being loaded onto a cart, and we'll get a report on him as soon as we can. But let's go back to the interception.
Well, the interception surprising Shane Matthews, who is very careful with the football. Tough third and long, trying to make a play, looking for something down the middle. Too many defenders there. Nice interception by Brant Boyer.
And for Shane Matthews on the season, that's his fourth interception, or his fifth interception. And two today. There's Boyer, the former Jacksonville Jaguar.
Usually when it's third and like over 15 in the National Football League, if you throw it down the field, it's going to be in trouble because they're going to play the situation, the defensive players. And you saw at that time, Greg, once it got past about 15 yards, there were three Cleveland Browns in position to make the play.
Bears and Matthews were looking at a third and 19. So now Cleveland, excellent field position, the Chicago 42. James Jackson, the lone back behind Couch. Play fake. Couch throws over the middle, in and out of the hands of Kevin Johnson, his intended receiver. And let's check in with Jim Nance in New York. Jim.
Well, here's how the Seahawks respond to a Tony Banks touchdown pass. They come right back on their next series. Sean Alexander takes it 41 yards, matching sevens at Washington. Let's go back to Greg and Phil.
All right, Jim, thank you. Second and 10 for Couch in the ground. Coming this way is Jackson, and Jackson is hit hard at the 43.
As you were watching that play, you saw Tim Couch come up the line of scrimmage, and he's checking off, changing the running play. And let's look at number 54, Brian Urlacher. Just too much speed sometimes for offensive linemen to get out there and block him.
We look at the numbers on Brian Urlacher, certainly a budding star. And, you know, anytime you can play the middle linebacker position here in Chicago, the fans are going to be behind you. Jamel White and Aaron Shea in the backfield as Couch works. Ball tipped as he let it go, and it's incomplete. So the punting unit will come onto the field.
Well, we heard it many times, and we even heard it from Greg Blush, the defensive coordinator for the Bears. On third down, they are tough, and Cleveland knows if they're going to have a good offensive day, they're going to have to do it on first and second.
So once again, Leon Johnson stands at his own 10-yard line awaiting the punt. From the 8. And back up to about the 15-yard line. 34-yard punt, 7-yard return. We'll come back right after this.
What would you do if someone passed you the keys to a Pontiac Grand Prix for a week?
I'm out, man. Let's go.
I'm out to see the world. San Francisco, here we go.
Are we having fun yet?
Doesn't take much to have fun, does it?
It's like riding on a surfboard.
You're going to have to call me Dixie if I wear this.
All right, Dixie.
I can smell the salt water from here.
Give us a swell, baby.
So what would you do with the Pontiac Grand Prix? Tell us at Pontiac.com.
There's some good surf out there.
My official title is Touchdown Boogie Coordinator.
Now, to me, it's not the end zone. It's the groove zone.
Move those hips. Move it.
I'm hard on my guys because it takes commitment.
There you're getting it. There you're getting it.
Scoring's just a way to get them into the end zone.
Strike a pose, baby.
Then,
good job.
It's showtime.
Bud Light celebrates those who like to celebrate.
Winning isn't everything. Shaking a righteous booty, that is.
Dear Kurt, how is training camp? Are you getting along with the other boys? This new chunky soup will fill you up right after a fun-filled day.
No, no, no!
New chunky beef rib roast with potatoes is loaded with lean chunks of savory rib roast for a taste of home while you're away.
Lights out!
I miss you, Pumpkin. Love, Mom.
You all right, Kurt?
Yeah, I'm okay.
New Campbell's Chunky Homestyle Classics.
Like Mom used to make.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Campbell's Chunky, soup that eats like a meal. And by Capital One, who asks, what's in your wallet?
I see. Phil, I have an idea what I'd like to eat at halftime if you're taking orders. Bears haven't done themselves any favor. fumble and two interceptions in three possessions, and they start now from their own 15-yard line. And here comes Thomas. Across the 15, out to about the 18-yard line coming into this game. The rookie out of Michigan led the league in yards per attempt, coming in at 5.9 per carry.
Terrell, good offensive line, and something we just saw in that last play that the Bears like to do. Their wide receivers are all big, physical kind of guys. They can catch the ball over the middle and all that, but they are expected to block. And that time, the wide receiver, they have to come in motion a lot of times, and they have to block big defensive ends, and they do a very good job of it.
On second and seven, Matthew. Over the middle, incomplete. Intended for Thomas. Now, speaking of defensive ends, saw Keith McKenzie carted off. They are going to x-ray his left ankle, and we'll update you as soon as we know more. Dick Geron looking for something to kickstart his offense.
Well, he's looking at his offense and going, wow, this is not as smooth as it was last week. We were pretty much going up and down the field. Well, the difference is this week, Cleveland being a little more aggressive, really getting up on the receivers, not giving Shane Matthews room to drop the ball off to his second and third receiver.
Five wide receivers on third and seven. Matthews going to go down the field, has a receiver open, and he's got it. Des White to midfield and more, and it's a first down for Chicago. 33 yards on the play, and a perfectly thrown ball by Shane Matthews.
Well, Greg, the one thing they do, just look at the lineup. You got four receivers to the right for Chicago. They get Des White, just him and the defender down the field against Anthony Henry. Shane Matthews sees it, says, hey, I got half the field with Des White against Anthony Henry. Makes a good decision and makes a perfect throw.
33 yards on the play. First down for the Bears at midfield. Back to the ground game. Thomas trying to kick it outside and maybe got a yard. Dwayne Rudd, Jameer Miller with the stop, second and nine.
You know, you see a lot of different things every week in the NFL, but four receivers to one side and one by himself on the other, I see that about two times a year. So Chicago Bears, John Shoup designing something new. Cleveland makes an adjustment, and the Bears get what they want.
Shane Matthews pressed into service last week. Outstanding effort coming on in relief of Jim Miller, who suffered a hip pointer. Didn't recover well enough this week to play or to start today. So Matthews gets the call. The pitch for Matthews. Blockers in front of him as he tries to turn the corner and slips down short of the 50-yard line. He lost a yard on the play. And with time running down in the first quarter, the Bears will be looking at a third and 10 when we come back to Soldier Field in Chicago, where a turnover led to a fumble return for the touchdown by Courtney Brown, and Cleveland leads it 7-0.
Great. Credit card bill.
Look at these fees.
Honey?
One rate for purchases, higher rate for cash advances, and those telemarketers.
Relax. We switched to Capital One's new no-hassle card.
Introducing Capital One's new no-hassle platinum card. No balance transfer fees, no telemarketing, one low fixed rate.
Honey?
What's in your wallet?
In and out. Good. Keep the victim calm. And one, and two, and three.
Okay, there you go. That's over 100 channels, sports, news, digital music. Installation's free, and it's only $31.99 a month.
Just $31.99 a month gets you over 100 channels of DirecTV programming. Right now with free professional installation.
So it was the digital music that...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Whoa. Did you bake this bread? Is this fresh baked? Do you have any idea where it came from?
No.
I didn't think so. Come on, let's go for a ride. So, what do you think? Don't you just love the smell of fresh baked cardboard? Subway bakes their bread fresh every day. Right, Nancy?
Right, Jim. Subway's got four new delicious Subway Selects at the Southwest Chicken with tangy Southwest sauce. All on fresh-baked gourmet bread and all made fresh right in front of you.
Once you go fresh, you never go back.
Subway, eat fresh!
Late Show with David Letterman.
I may be calling you.
Dial it up Monday.
Well, we talked about the Chicago wide receivers, how they have to block in the run game. Here's David Terrell. Watch Jameer Miller. He's going to block him. They're going to try to go around to the outside. Now, I said they tried. I didn't say they always got it done. But tough job to block those big linebackers or defensive ends.
Jameer Miller comes into this game with 6 sacks and an interception. And is the hard-charging point man of that Cleveland defense. 3rd and 10. Evades the rush, but doesn't elude Greg Spires, number 96.
Well, Greg Spires gets the sack, but Courtney Brown, number 92, watching from the top. Here he comes. I missed him. It was the wrong guy. It was Mark Smith, number 93, from the inside. Just came so fast, made Shane Matthews move, and when he did, Greg Spires gets the sack.
And now another sack against a Chicago Bear team that only allowed 2 coming into the game today. Dennis Northcutt from the 10. Going the other way and dragged down at the 12-yard line by Larry Wiggum. 44-yard punt, 7-yard return. We're coming back to Soldier Field after this.
Let's belt it out for your Pittsburgh Steelers!
I don't care what stadium you work for, all right? If you want to write a check for who let the dogs out, I'm still going to need to see some ID.
Next time, use the Visa check card instead of cash or checks. It'll get you in, out, and on with life.
Introducing new Castrol AccuVision Rain Repellent. Unlike Rain-X, AccuVision can go on in just 1 minute, so you can easily apply it whenever it's convenient. New Castrol AccuVision, the 1 minute rain repellent.
Is your dandruff sending the wrong signals?
Go! Go!
No, no.
Get Selsun Power. Doctors recommend Selsun Blue.
Man, that dude's awesome.
Get Selsun Power.
It was the mountains and the snow and the water below.
Are you ready?
And you will know it's cold at last when the Coors Light hits your glass.
Are you ready for a cold one?
Are you ready for a cold Coors Light?
Are you ready?
Are you ready for a cold Coors Light?
Are you ready for a cold one?
Gotta watch.
He's autistic.
A witness with a photographic memory.
You just have to get the film out of his head.
Can he help catch a killer?
Tell me what you saw.
All new CSI. Then, they said it could never happen here, but it did. Thursday, one drama will show you how the CIA is attempting to wipe out this threat. An all new agency after CSI, CBS Thursday.
As you see, the Sears Tower, part of the Chicago skyline, will remind you, you can log on to NFL.com and vote for the AFC and NFC All-Star teams to play in this year's Pro Bowl. Vote now, NFL.com or your AOL keyword, NFL.com. On first down, Couch, with time, throws over the middle, and that's complete to the tight end, O.J. Santiago, across the 20 to about the 23-yard line. 7-yard pickup, and it'll be 2nd and 3.
Now, see, I'm trained. I've done so many Indianapolis Colts games over the year, and I know Bruce Arians comes from Indianapolis, so when Tim Couch makes a play-action fake, I'm looking down the field because I know they're trying to make a big play. Now, that's twice they've run play-action, and 2 times there has been a receiver open down the field, but Tim Couch has not seen him.
Now, Bruce Arians did tell us we will take our shots down the field. He says he likes to go deep at least 5 times a game. On 2nd and 3, coming this way is James Jackson. Cuts it back and getting up to the 30-yard line and enough for a first down.
Now, when you see Tim Couch come to the line of scrimmage and call out a play, what they're doing and what they like to do, they don't want to put all the pressure on the play caller, and that's Bruce Arians. So he gives Tim Couch what they call a check with me. It's usually 2 runs and a pass, He comes to the line of scrimmage, decides which play is the best, and calls it for the offensive unit.
You saw guard Chris Valerio headed off to the locker room with what appears to be a leg injury. We'll check on that. First down for the Browns at the 30-yard line. It's just their second first down of the day. Couch batted at the line, and it falls incomplete. Ted Washington got a paw up to knock that down.
Washington.
3 years in San Francisco, one in Denver, six with Buffalo in his first season here in Chicago. And Ted Washington has made an impact.
Got it with his arm. See, it helps to have arms that are about a foot wide. But Ted Washington, one of the big reasons he said to us, he goes, hey, this defense, we can be awesome. And this is from a veteran player who knows what it takes to have a good defense.
Second and 10. Here comes the Bears blitz. The give is to the right side. Jackson can't cut it back, and he's down at about the 28-yard line. Brian Robinson, number 98, the defensive end on that side, led the charge.
Well, the Bears that time crowd the line of scrimmage. It's a blitz. Look at all the defenders up there. The Browns, they do not have a lead blocker, so there cannot be much deception when it comes to the running game. When the running back goes to the right, there's where it goes. You can't, nobody's going to be cutting back going to the other side. And the Bears, terrific at pursuing the football.
Third and 12. Couch throws this side. That's complete to Jamel White out of the backfield and comes up short of the first down at the 38-yard line. He's about 2 yards shy. Tony Parrish made the stop. They needed 12 yards. They got 10. And now on to kick once again, Chris Gardocki, his third punt of the day, and has an NFL record running. He now has 767 consecutive punts without a block. .768. Drives this one. Leon Johnson from the 17. Across the 20 and out to the 22-yard line. Anthony Denman makes the stop, and we'll take a break.
Saturn is working to keep our economy strong in jobs, in commerce, and in spirit. As part of that effort, we're providing interest-free financing on every new coupe, sedan, and wagon we make. Come visit your Saturn retailer and keep America rolling.
Look at this workmanship.
You could make a lot of lira selling these in New York.
Yeah, look at these prices. These guys don't know what they got.
They're clueless. Try asking the old guy if he can handle a production of 10,000 of these.
No problem, signora.
What's it say?
They have 2 million units warehoused in New Jersey.
New Jersey?
New Jersey. New Jersey.
The right infrastructure can take your business anywhere, even New Jersey.
Bye-bye.
What gets a child to college? The support of her family, of course. And now, the savings families can create with AT&T and You Promise. For every minute you spend on long-distance calls from home, AT&T will contribute to your child's You Promise college savings account. Get grandparents, relatives, friends to sign up, and their AT&T calls grow the savings even more. Because the more people behind a college student, the better. Start now. Enroll at att.com/youpromise.
America loves its country. Get ready
for the CMA Awards. It's country's biggest night.
Award goes to...
Celebrate the sounds of our nation. Join stars Dixie Chicks, Tim McGraw, Trisha Yearwood, Garth Brooks, and more. Vince Gill hosts...
Live from Nashville.
The CMA Awards. CBS Wednesday.
I want to remind you, coming up on the Nextel Halftime Report, Jim, Mike, Randy, Jerry, scores, highlights, and the latest NFL news coming up next on the Nextel Halftime Report. Anthony Thomas, Damon Shelton, as you take a look at the advantage the Bears enjoy in time of possession and plays run, but they trail on the scoreboard 7-0. And that play doesn't get very much of anything as Mark Smith and Jameer Miller combine for the tackle after a 1 yard gain. Well, you know, we've heard so much about, there's Kevin Doggins, who has come on to replace Chris Villarreal. Villarreal, we are told, suffering a strained right hip. We've heard so much about this Chicago offense, and Shane Matthews told us the other day, hey, I'm a dink and dunk guy.
That he is, so he is playing in the offense that is for him because they do a terrific job with the short passing game.
Throws at this side, and his arm was hit as he let go. And number 99, Orpheus Roy, came out of the pack celebrating, so we're going to assume he got the hit on
yes.
Shane Matthews' arm.
And it's hard to dink and dunk when you're getting pressure from the defensive line. And Chicago, only two sacks this season coming into today's game, but Shane Matthews, he has seen more pressure in the first quarter and a little bit of the second quarter than he did all of last week against the San Francisco 49ers. Sacked twice. Hurried, knocked down a couple times. And when that happens to a quarterback, that leads to bad decisions because all of a sudden you go, I got to be quicker. And the quicker you are, sometimes the worse your decision-making can be.
From the shotgun on third and nine. Got a hand on him, and down he goes. The Chicago Bear quarterbacks sacked twice all season long coming into this game, now sacked for the third time.
Now, this time I know it was Courtney Brown, Greg. I saw him come around from the outside, and what speed Courtney Brown has. Number 92 to the top of your screen. Good move. Actually getting ready to get double teamed by Rex Tucker, and it's still not enough to stop him.
Knocked Matthews down to one knee, and Butch Davis celebrating on the sideline. Dennis Northcutt from his own 27. 35. Turns the corner. Midfield. To the Bears 45 and down to the 41-yard line. 50-yard punt, 30-yard return. Excellent field position for the Browns when we come back.
Retirement plan working? Sun America can help. Just ask your financial advisor. Sun America, the retirement specialist.
Saturn is working to keep our economy strong in jobs, in commerce, and in spirit. As part of that effort, we're providing interest-free financing on every new coupe, sedan, and wagon we make. Come visit your Saturn retailer and keep America rolling.
You're gonna fall in love with the new grilled sourdough bacon cheeseburger at Burger King. Indulge your craving in a hot, delicious quarter pound of flame-broiled beef with melted Swiss cheese and four strips of crispy bacon stacked up on two slices of grilled sourdough bread. It's for a limited time, so head over to Burger King today and get ready to fall in love.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Heineken. It's all about the beer. Heineken. Sun America, the retirement specialist. And by Burger King, home of the Whopper.
Welcome back to Soldier Field in Chicago. Greg Gumbel, Phil Sims, Armin Katsayan, and the Browns with the football at the Chicago 41-yard line. Just under 10 minutes to play here in the first half. The Browns with a 7-0 lead. Jackson, right side, spins off of a tackle and is down at the 39-yard line. After all is said and done, it'll be a 2-yard gain. Brian Urlacher with the stop, and let's check in with Armin.
Thanks, Greg. You know, 5 wins in a row, a lot of talk in this town about the Bears defense and comparisons to the great 1985 team. Well, defensive coordinator Greg Blasch kind of put the kibosh on that on Monday when he walked into the team meeting with a gas mask on his face, basically saying to the defense, you guys stink, especially after giving up 31 points to the San Francisco 49ers. Greg, back to you.
Yeah, Armin, it is a little early for most sane-thinking people to begin making those comparisons. Jackson again. Jackson is going nowhere as he is dropped back at the 45-yard line. Phil Daniels, number 93, led the charge.
Well, when your defense can just line up and single-handedly win the football game for you, then you compare it to the 85 Bears, because that's what they could do. But there are some players in this Bear defense now that could have started for that team and who had the ability to be what we say difference makers. They can make big plays that determine the outcome of the game.
Cleveland Browns have managed just 12 rushing yards on 7 attempts. Couch from the shotgun steps up, throws, has it batted at the line of scrimmage, and it falls incomplete.
Boy, and I can see why they talked about, the Browns talked about this third down defense. Tim Couch, you better be glad this ball was tipped by Phillip Daniels, because it's going to be picked off. Throwing back across the grain, defenders were running to the receiver. Pressure on the quarterback.
Browns 0 for their last 4 on third down. Leon Johnson is deep. Gardocki. Fair catch is made at the 13-yard line. So the Bears still trying to find the scoreboard. They trail 7-0.
Some situations call for trucks with more power. So engineer Mark Ferrone and the team have made GMC Sierras the most powerful line of pickups in the world. And to help manage all that torque, they've also given Sierra technically advanced braking systems. Mark may be obsessed with power, but he's not crazy. From professional-grade people come professional-grade trucks.
Tell me, when will you be mine? Tell me, quando, quando, quando? We can share a love divine. Please don't make me wait again. When will you say yes to me?
NFL.com now and America Online. Get live game day coverage and real-time stats at AOL keyword NFL.com.
The world's greatest golfers will claim history as their own. The PGA Tour is on CBS Sports.
Two of the oldest and most venerable franchises in the National Football League, the Browns and the Chicago Bears, share 120 NFL seasons with some of the greatest names to have ever played the game, ranging from Sayers and Peyton for the Bears to Jim Brown, Lou Groza, Otto Graham for the Cleveland Browns, and don't forget coaches like Paul Brown and George Halas included in the mix. Chris Valeriel is back on the field for the Bears at right guard as Chicago takes over at its own 12-yard line. Mackey on the roll. On the comeback, he hits his man across the 25-yard line, and that's Marty Booker. Booker's first catch of the day, and that's good for a first down for the Bears. Marty Booker, we talked with on Friday. I think the first thing you pointed out is those are the biggest hands I've ever seen on a receiver.
Right. No wonder you have good hands. Physical looking receiver. You can see that he's built over 200 pounds. It's one of the reasons why he can go over the middle and catch those tough throws.
Thomas running a little across the 30 to the 34. Mark Smith made the tackle. The bad news for the Cleveland defense. Defensive end Keith McKenzie, a fractured left ankle. He will not return today.
Well, the Chicago Bears offense, they believe the reason they're having success is being physical, and that means running the football. And this offensive line only giving up a couple sacks coming in today's game. A big reason for that, hey, you're on defense, you better dig in and try to stop the running game of the Bears first.
Talking about this being a physical game, Corey Fuller is down on the field at the 33-yard line and having his right foot and ankle looked at.
But, you know, I look at this Bears offense, Greg, and I look at the offensive line. It's got some veteran players, some good players. Then you put in a running back like Anthony Thomas, and you really get what you want, a physical running game. You know, Anthony Thomas is a guy that gets, you know, his value can be overlooked because I don't know if he's a 40 and 50-yard type of running back, but, boy, he can get a lot of those 4- and 5-yard gains that put offenses in just great position to make good calls on second and third down.
Thomas has 64 of the Bears' 96 total yards. And while Fuller is looked at and now gets to his feet, we want to talk about the schedule of games here on CBS next Sunday. And Phil and I are going to be in Indianapolis. The Colts winners today, the Miami Dolphins winners today, and they will clash at the RCA Dome. Another game that might be of interest, these Cleveland Browns hosting the Pittsburgh Steelers, who are not going to be the happiest troops that you will ever see as they move into Cleveland. It all begins with the NFL today. Jim Nantz and the whole gang, and well, that gang is growing, isn't it? A lot of people coming your way next Sunday on CBS. So Fuller is helped off the field, and he'll be replaced by the rookie out of University of South Florida, Anthony Henry.
Yes, and to answer your question, Greg, yes, the gang is growing.
Meanwhile, the Bears and Shane Matthews will see if they can sustain an offensive drive and avoid the sack which the Cleveland Browns brought with them to the stadium today. Second and two. And that physical nature that you were just talking about, I'm going to prove to you again that every once in a while I do listen to you.
I know you do.
Because
I do
recall you saying that if there's one way an offense can really make an imprint on a defense, if you can run the football successfully, it just wears them down.
Well, it does. It does a lot of things. But the biggest thing it does, it allows an offense now to dictate what they want to do. And John Shoup, the offensive coordinator, he has a wonderful phrase, conflict of assignment. That's what happens to a defense when you run the ball.
Matthews over the middle, complete over midfield to number 83, David Terrell, the rookie out of Michigan. And now penalty markers fly. And Gerald Austin going to come over and check it out.
A little extra activity on the ground.
We have an unsportsmanlike call for taunting. Number 20 of the defense, 15 yards, first down.
Earl Little is the guilty party.
But Greg, you talked about it. They run the football with power. Now all of a sudden, Shane Matthews has the time to throw it. Nice catch by David Terrell. And then Earl Little, number 20, gets him down.
And then the taunting afterwards. He was untouched.
Oh, you know, you just cannot do that. And that's the one, that's a new rule in the league, and it's been terrific this year. You don't see it too often, but when you do it, the officials are going to throw that flag.
So from the 31, Thomas turning the corner, left side, 20, 15, penalty marker is down back at about the 33-yard line. 18-yard pickup, and this one looks like it's going to come back.
Holding, 78 offense, 10 yards, repeat first down.
Well, left tackle Blake Brockemeyer being sure that Thomas could turn that corner.
Well, a couple things. Watch Brockemeyer, number 78. Oh, just that last little bit, he grabbed the jersey of Tyrone Rogers, number 78. He had him blocked.
Over here.
He was not going to get off that block and make the tackle, but, hey, the thing that jumped out at me, Anthony Thomas, he's got a step, and he went around that end awfully easy.
So that'll back the Bears up to the 41-yard line, and they're looking at a first and 20. We are under 6 minutes to play for the first half. Matthews, quick pass to the side, and that's knocked down by Tyrone Rogers. One of those screens that John Shoup told us he likes to keep the defense honest and keep that rush a little bit
sedated. Keep them honest, but let's see if They never get Tyrone Rogers to the ground. Brockemeyer just drops too deep. Usually in a screen like that, the offensive lineman will go down low and make you protect yourself or cut you to the ground. But I'm sure that's one play they worked on quite a bit during their off week, Greg, is because Chicago does throw a lot of the quick screens to the outside.
Second and 20. Matthew underneath, complete to Dez White. And White wrestled down at the 35-yard line. Wally Rayner and Earl Little making the stop after a 6-yard pickup.
Well, that's what they're really good at, this Bears offense. Sending people down the field. Look at it. Marty Booker goes up the field. Dez White goes all the way underneath the umpire, picks up the short game.
You go down and cut right at the umpire.
Yeah, that's right. Well, you want to catch pass in this league now as a wide receiver. You're going to take some big hits, especially when you run short ones over the middle.
Third and 14. Bears need the 21-yard line for a first down. Matthews pulled it down and now goes deep and overthrows everybody. Dez White was the man trying to make a move and break free. And it really didn't fool any of the Cleveland defenders.
Well, he's going to make a double move, but when you're Shane Matthews or when you're a quarterback, if you're going to throw it away, make sure you get it out of bounds. That time, Percy Ellsworth almost made the interception on the throwaway by Shane Matthews.
Now, Paul Edinger, who was long this year, is 48 yards, is going to try this one from 53 yards out. And if he gets any advantage of the wind, it'll be with him. Direct snap, and he's going to put it. And going to roll it down the 10 to the 5, and it's killed at the 1-yard line. Philip Daniel batted it back, and Edinger says, yeah, we did what we wanted.
Oh, say, can I have the new software IT didn't approve?
Fred, I promised someone remote access. What is remote access?
At CDW, we understand what it can be like in IT. That's why we have top name brands in stock, so you get the solutions you need when you need them. Like the HP NetServer LP2000R. Great performance and manageability. And a 2U rack-optimized server, only from HP.
Fred, here is another request that can't be done in time.
HP and CDW. Computing solutions built for business.
No matter who you are, or what you're into, isn't it nice to know you'll be accepted?
That's why the Redskins' biggest fans, the Hoggets, make sure to bring their Visa cards to the Forecast Boutique. Visa, the official card of the NFL.
Do I look fat in this dress?
Yes!
America's best night of comedy is CBS Monday. First, a hospital visit brings Doug face-to-face with the world's most annoying patient.
Ho! Ho!
The King of Queens. Then is Greg a bad dad?
You've set the bar so low I can do the bare minimum and feel like the world's greatest dad.
And you're welcome.
Yes, dear. Next, Ray's wife and mom team up on a devious plan.
It's like voodoo.
And Dr. Becker's not afraid of modern medicine.
Get me out of here!
All new comedy, CBS Monday.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Visa. It's everywhere NFL fans want to be. And by CDW, computing solutions built for business.
4:48 to play in the first quarter, in the first half. And you see total yardage there. Not much to speak of for the Cleveland Browns, but they lead at 7-0 as Couch works from his own 1-yard line with the fans right in his ear. He's going to throw. That one's complete to Santiago out to the 19 or 20-yard line and a first down.
Boy, nice job by Tim Couch. That time, he hangs in. Even though he had a short receiver open in Mike Sellers, he hangs in to throw it down the field. O.J. Santiago and Ted Washington hits Tim Couch just as he lets the football go. Nice job. You could see Tim Couch relaxed, kind of bent his knees a little. That way you can absorb the hit from a 350-pound lineman.
Timeout.
And with the play clock winding down, Tim Couch uses a timeout here, the first of the first half for the Browns. 4:26 to play.
The handcrafting, the pruning, the selection. The anticipation. The patience. The timing. The moment. Turning Leaf, handcrafted for moments like these.
4:26 to play in the first half, and the Browns have escaped the shadow of their own goalpost, moved it out to the 20-yard line. Plenty of time and two timeouts remaining. Couch looking. He's trying to spin out of trouble and goes down at the 13-yard line. Phillip Daniels again applying the pressure for the Bears.
Well, that was just good coverage down the field that time, Greg. And Tim Couch had time to throw it. He's going to look back to his right for the deep receiver, Kevin Johnson. He's not open, and Phillip Daniels pulls him down.
Loss of 7 on the play, 2nd and 17, as we come up on 4 minutes to play in the first half. Couch with a bullet. That's complete to Kevin Johnson.
Now, you know, last night, Greg, we had a chance to talk to Bruce Arians, the offensive coordinator for the Browns. Him and Greg Blasch, defensive coordinator for the Bears, worked together in Indianapolis. And remember what he said? Oh, I know what Greg wants to do. He just wants to slap us in the mouth. That's all he wants to do. He just wants to kick us. And he goes, then on third downs, he's going to be creative and try to confuse the young players on the Browns offense.
Nice to know what your opposite number is up to.
Exactly.
Jamel White in on 3rd and 10. Couch, quick pass to the far side, complete to Kevin Johnson, and Johnson is brought down shy of the 25-yard line. Warwick Goldman and Walt Harris make the stop after a 5-yard gain, and so the Browns have to kick it away.
Warwick Goldman, gain of 5 on the play. 4th and 5.
Well, take away the early turnover and fumble return for a touchdown by Courtney Brown. It is exactly the defensive battle that we were looking forward to. Leon Johnson lost the football and then falls on it again at the 36 or 37-yard line. We remind you, coming up tonight on CBS, share a night with America as your favorite stars celebrate the best in television, including a special live performance by Barbara Streisand on the Emmy Awards. That's tonight on CBS. So Shane Matthews talking things over with John Shoup. As you look at the comparative numbers, Couch and Matthews, the two interceptions by Matthews standing out.
Well, sitting up here now, I'm not envious of the quarterbacks as I watch the defenses, the speed, how aggressive they are, and it just not a lot of easy opportunities for either quarterback so far.
Bears with all 3 timeouts remaining. Matthews going to throw far side, complete, nice grab by Des White. Across midfield and out of bounds after a 16-yard pickup.
Well, he just snatched that out of the air. Des White comes under a little scrutiny sometimes because he will drop a pass. He dropped a few when he was at Georgia Tech, but when you watch him on film or you see him in person, the one thing that jumps out, he is one of the few wide receivers that can really create a lot of space between him and the defensive back. That's a quarterback's best friend.
The pitch to Thomas. Thomas, nowhere to go, dragged down at the 45-yard line. And Courtney Brown.
I'd say Courtney Brown's making a pretty good impact on his first game back.
Not bad for a guy who said he thought his biggest problem would be getting up to game speed in his first game back. 2-minute warning. We'll come back to Chicago after this.
You want to tell me what made you a criminal?
What made you a criminal?
Nothing made me a criminal. I am a criminal.
Brokey's tired. Cops are looking for him.
I gotta get out of town. I gotta go.
You've just become more trouble than you're worth. I hate to do anything as dramatic as count to 3, but 1, 2, 3.
Gene Hackman, Danny DeVito, in the film by David Mamet.
He's so cool when he goes to bed, sheep count him.
Heist, rated R, starts Friday.
Some situations call for trucks with more power. So engineer Mark Verone and the team have made GMC Sierras the most powerful line of pickups in the world. And to help manage all that torque, they've also given Sierra technically advanced braking systems. Mark may be obsessed with power, but he's not crazy. From professional-grade people come professional-grade trucks.
Okay, the coast is clear.
Good. Listen, Teddy, everyone's excited about the new Windows XP, right?
Yeah.
Well, now we get them really fired up. We take XP, we load it onto our 300S, we add a free CD burner, include a flat screen, and we sell it all for $9.99.
$9.99 with a flat screen?
Teddy, did I stutter?
The show must go on. The Emmy Awards. The stars will shine brighter as we celebrate the power of television. The Emmys live, CBS Tonight.
2 minutes away from halftime, we remind you, the Nextel halftime report comes your way with Jim, Mike, Randy, Jerry from New York. The Nextel halftime report coming up. There's Courtney Brown, who we were just laughing as we went to commercial, that he just hoped that he would be able to get back to game speed, and you'd have to say that the young man has made an impact.
Yeah, he has, Greg. You know, players like Courtney Brown can change your football team, because when you're an offense, you got to put a lot of thought and work into trying to stop a player of his quality, and it just opens up opportunities for other defensive players.
Matthews running out of time and now throws out of the backfield is Thomas, and look at Thomas across the 45 to the 37, and he appears to have enough for a first down.
Boy, that's just a nice job. That's a veteran quarterback who sees the defense. All the players drop back, and he just shuffles in the pocket and waits till Anthony Thomas gets out, dumps it off, and picks up a first down.
Well, you were right about his speed. He can accelerate on first down. Thomas again. Thomas to the 30, 25, 20, and run out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. That's another first down.
Boy, Anthony Thomas just has the look of a football player that's been in these situations many times, carried the football at Michigan, and just comes in and adjusts to the pro game right away. This time, Cleveland comes with a blitz. Nobody there to pick him up. Reads the block. Just all the little things does them very well. And Fred Baxter, number 84, makes a nice block on Dwayne Rudd.
Prior to this, the deepest penetration by the Bears had been the 31-yard line of the Browns. First down. And timeout is called by the Cleveland Browns. They use their second timeout. Stop the clock with a minute 23 to play. And the Bears threatening.
Oh, hello. Have you heard about 1-800-MEDICARE? Yes, you have, because I just told you. Must be broken. You can find out what Medicare covers. Get information on staying healthy. Whoops. They'll even tell you what Medigap is, which is important to those who have a gap in their Medi. Oh. The bottom line is, for healthcare questions, turn to the experts at Medicare.
1-800-MEDICARE. Helping you help yourself.
That graphic tells you right there how outstanding the Chicago Bears have been once they get inside the 20-yard line.
Now, you say all the time, you listen to me. So if you listen to me, Greg, why are they good in the red zone? Like any team, you've got to be able to run the football, too. When you have double threats down near the goal line, that's why you're a good red zone offense.
Here comes Thomas to the 10. Rodgers and McCutcheon coming up for the tackle after a 3-yard gain. And the Bears are looking at a 2nd and 7, and the clock continues to move, coming up on 65 seconds to play in the first half.
Yeah, the clock is not a factor for the Chicago Bears. The only factor it is just to make sure you score and you run as much time off of the clock as you can. Don't even give Cleveland a chance for a 2-minute drill.
Matthews to throw. Thomas diving forward to about the 6-yard line. And the Bears call timeout and stop the clock with 48 seconds to play.
That's the thing I noticed about this Bears offense when I was getting ready to do this game. Shane Matthews that time looks to his right, three receivers, and if it doesn't look good right away, he turns and finds the short receiver. That time it's Anthony Thomas and picks up a few yards.
Now, Shane Matthews, as we've said, starting today in place of Jim Miller, but Dick Geron will say there isn't really much difference in his quarterbacks and his offense doesn't change very much.
No, the offense doesn't change at all. The difference is in personality. Jim Miller, he's real emotional, I guess you would say, as a quarterback. Shane Matthews, you watch him, his facial expressions, his body language, it never changes. Always relaxed, very low key, and he plays that way. Throws the ball nice and soft, in rhythm, and fits this offense very well.
Run! Drop one!
Third and five. Matthews throws, coming across, has it complete to Marty Booker. And Booker, looking for first down yardage, appears to have it.
Now that time, the Bears did so many different things before the snap that I just lost sight of everything they were doing. And then he threw it to Marty Booker. I didn't even know where he came from. They got motion to the right. They shift to the right. He looks to the right. And who's he throw it to? A receiver coming underneath from the left. And that's what a defensive player sees, too. They see all the action to the right side. They see the quarterback. They think, well, he's going to throw it over here. No, Marty Booker comes underneath. And that's what you have to be, I think, too, Greg. Besides running the football in the red zone, you got to have an offense that's very deceptive because the defenders know they got the end zone protecting them. They don't have to drop back as far sometimes. And so if you don't trick them a little, it's hard just to continuously make plays down here.
That first down story seems to be in complete contrast to the scoreboard. The Bears still looking for their first points of the day. 33 seconds to play. Bears have one timeout remaining. First and goal from the two. Thomas, the lone back. Matthews rolls, looks back the other way, now throws, and batted down at the goal line. Anthony Henry, the fourth round draft pick, batted it down at the goal line.
That's just good defense by the Cleveland Browns. Don't take a chance when you're down in this close. And real fortunate again, Shane Matthews, that's not picked off. But the initial play was made to throw to a wide receiver quick into the flat. The Browns knew it. They took care of it. And Shane Matthews had nowhere to go.
Matthews now 5 out of 6 on this drive. Second and goal from the two. Looks right. Waiting and throws it away. It'll be third and goal.
David Terrell is really upset. I heard him yelling at Shane Matthews because look at this. It's him and Anthony Henry one-on-one, and right from the start, I thought Shane Matthews would throw it to him right away because he saw that they're one-on-one, nobody else out there to help. Terrell is a big receiver, but Shane Matthews went to the other side.
10th play of this drive, third and goal. Touchdown for Anthony Thomas, his fourth of the season. And now Edinger will try to pull the Bears into a 7-7 tie. And he does. Good solid drive by the Chicago Bears to close out this first half.
Good drive. Shane Matthews did a terrific job in the drive, but the offensive line just gets the push. Look at some of those blocks. Olin Kruntz, the center. Terrific job. And Anthony Thomas goes in almost untouched.
and Dick Geron on the sideline. That's about as much emotion as you'll catch from Dick Geron today.
Yeah, he doesn't show a lot. He lets his coaches coach, and he really makes the players, I think, feel relaxed and confident in what they're going to do just by his demeanor.
Well, how can you not be impressed by that rookie and his ability to run the football with speed and with power?
Well, Anthony Thomas is one of these players. He looks a lot better when you see him in person.
And he didn't look too bad on film
either.
Yeah,
he looked good on film too, but taking advantage of his blocks, and this is what I really like, has a tremendous feel in the passing game. Stayed in and blocked a couple times, released at the proper, just at the last second. Shane Matthews, look for him, boom, drop the ball to him.
The kickoff. Jamel White to the 20, 25, and goes down at about the 26-yard line. And a marker is down in the middle of the field.
See, I think, Greg, going back, Dick Geron, you saw the emotion. He's going, man, we've made every mistake in the world out here in the first half. And he is
during the return, holding 55, 10 yards, first down.
And, of course, he's ecstatic to be tied after all the mistakes they've made.
There is Geron. Much talk in Chicago this week about how the 5-1 start for the Bears, has it really boosted his chances of continuing as the head coach? And Jerry Angelo, the general manager, said, well, no, there's a whole season still to be played.
I like Dick Geron's his answer. He says, hey, I coach because I like the pressure. And the situation he's in now is like every coach. You just got to win. And when you win, that takes care of everything.
In the first minute of play, the Cleveland Browns score a touchdown. The Bears score in the final minute of play for a 7-7 tie. And let's go to Armin.
Coach, a lot of turnovers early on, but finally able to crack through thanks to Anthony Thomas.
Well, it didn't look good offensively early in the game. You know, we turned the ball over on a second play for a touchdown or whatever it was. Then we throw the tip ball for an interception, which happens. But we settled down. We stayed in it. Our defense really played strong and kept us in the game.
All right, Coach. Thank you. Greg.
All right, Armin, our halftime score, the Cleveland Browns 7, the Chicago Bears 7 coming up. We'll be sending you off to Jim Nance for the Nextel halftime report. Jim, Mike, Randy, and Jerry with scores, highlights, and the latest NFL news after these messages from your local station.
Hello?
Jackie.
Mr. President?
I love you.
Lyndon Johnson's secretly recorded phone calls tonight on 60 Minutes.
The Guardian, Tuesday on CBS. It's all here.
Somewhere in America, there are grandchildren and great-grandchildren and aunts and uncles and cousins around every corner. There's commotion and noise and joy and family. Somewhere in America.
You cannot spend money wildly and expect to get ahead. We drive a 3-year-old Lincoln Continental. It had one owner before us.
The car has conservative elegance.
Got complete inspection. The warranty is great. The only person who ever got rich off a designer dress was the designer.
Just sweep o' gelato.
My wife has a black belt in shopping.
Oh.
Technology inside, you can take Guinness Draft outside. Introducing Guinness Draft in a bottle.
Could you spot a terrorist? Tonight on the CBS 2 News at 10.
I'm Tracy Townsend. More traces of anthrax have been found in New York. We'll have the latest on that.
And the latest on a man police arrested at O'Hare trying to board a plane with several weapons. I'm John Davis. I'll have that story.
And we've all been told to be on guard, but do you know how to spot a terrorist? Vince Gerasoli talks with some experts.
I'm David Curley at Soldier Field. What do the Bears players think about their game with the Browns? You'll hear from them on CBS 2 News and Bears Extra after the Emmys.
Something extraordinary is coming to Amoco. It will change your gasoline buying experience, but it won't change your gasoline. You'll still be able to buy the same Amoco gasoline you've always bought. But the environment in which you buy it will be brighter, smarter, more inviting than ever before. And the best part is, this is just the beginning. BP, going beyond.
Last winter, we had a little cell phone mix-up.
He told our travel agent Steamboat Springs, but with the static, well...
You know, we tried to make the best of it.
Come on, kids.
There we go.
Who wants hot cocoa?
That's when we finally got free and clear with Sprint PCS. Real clear calls, and nationwide long distance included, which is great for us because we do have two kids.
Hey!
The Sprint PCS free and clear plan with nationwide long distance included. Every minute, every day.
Get 0% APR through November 18th. Make your move now. There's interest-free financing on every new Buick Century, LeSabre, Park Avenue, Regal, and the all-new Rendezvous. 0.0% APR makes Buick's award-winning quality, safety, and luxury more affordable than ever. These are the final days for you to pay no interest. See your Chicagoland or Northwest Indiana Buick dealer before November 18th.
Gotta watch.
He's autistic.
A witness with a photographic memory.
You just have to get the film out of his head.
Can he help catch a killer?
Tell me what you saw.
All new CSI. Then you see these words in the paper every day. They said it could never happen here. This Thursday, One Drama will show you how the CIA is attempting to wipe out this threat. Don't miss this compelling hour of television every American must see. An all new agency after CSI. CBS Thursday.
CBS Sports presents the Nextel Direct Connect Halftime Report. Nextel, get right through.
Yes, it is that time. Hello, friends. Welcome to the Nextel Halftime Report. Jim Nance from our NFL Today studio. It's along with Mike Ditka, Randy Cross, Jerry Glanville. Are you ready?
Good to be here, brother.
Okay, good
this is live.
You. This is live. And well, Mike, how about them Browns Bears?
Well, I'll tell you, this is old-fashioned football. I mean, the Browns get on the board first on a turnover, but the Bears come right back before the end of the half. A-Train is running the football, 17 for 43. Not a lot of yards, but they're doing the right things.
All right, let's go around the league. By the way, Doug Flutie's shaken up on a sack, and Drew Brees is in there right now, waiting word on Flutie for the rest of the way. How about the Chiefs, though, Randy?
This is just about a physical tail whipping right now between Dick Vermeil's Kansas City Chiefs and the really no-show so far San Diego Chargers.
All right, meanwhile, Seattle and Washington, talk about no-show. Hasselbeck picked twice, and the Redskins getting a running game today, too, from Davis, 81 yards and a touch.
Yeah, but watch the Redskins here, fake that, go down inside, three fakes, and you got a touchdown to the tight end.
Ooh, how about that? The Eagles trying to avenge a loss 4 weeks ago to Arizona, and McNabb has thrown two touchdowns. They up by 14. Lions got an interception return and a run back. Robert Bailey of a Garcia pass looking for the first win of the season. Big win on the season for the Ravens today, Mike.
Well, it was. I mean, here you get Cunningham, gets Shannon Sharp, but the difference in this football game is this guy right here. Brown misses 4 out of 5 field goals.
How glad are you that you've got a field goal kicker who's done it 34 straight games?
Everybody has a role. It takes a whole roster. And what a great day for football. Anytime you come to Pittsburgh, you get a great day. You get a great football game. And obviously, we're just thrilled to have it.
Bernstein there, and Matt Stover won it.
But down in Tennessee, Mark Brunell had a good game, but Steve McNair had a better game. The Titans had the ball for 37 minutes in this game. McNair, 2 rushing, 2 passing touchdowns.
Speaking of rushing, how about Peyton Manning?
Yeah, forget about Peyton. He became Archie right about here. Look at that speed. And to get it in, he becomes Brother Eli. The whole family scored.
33 yards, and here's Edgerrin James' replacement, Dominique Rhodes.
And the Rhodes hustle on down for 100 yards.
Down in Atlanta, Tom Brady impressive again for the Patriots.
He was not only good, he was lucky. Watch this. Doink! Here goes the ball. Little deflection, and this ends up a touchdown. And Brady put his hands in his head. He said, I am lucky.
He threw 2 legitimate ones, 3 overall, and the Panthers down in Miami lost.
Well, as good as the Carolina Panthers were last week against the Jets, not this week.
3 minutes to go at Green Bay, Mike.
Allen Ross, a 55-yard punt return. This puts a stake right in the box.
Leslie Visser was there.
Allen, you came back in the second week after missing 4 weeks. You definitely made an impression today. Tell us about the punt return.
All the guys in front of me said, hey, you know what, if we get another punt return, don't worry about the short kicks, don't worry about it this far. You just get the ball and we're going to give you time. And I just believe those guys. That's what a big part of this game is about, is believing those guys in front of me.
Cowboys and Giants overtime.
And here it was, the best Dane on the field. Was it Ron Dane, the running back? It was the kicker in overtime.
Yes, Morton Anderson from 42 yards. Biggest comeback for the Giants since 1986. They come back from 17 down to win it. Thanks for being with us on the Nextel Halftime Report.
CBS Sports presents the Nextel Direct Connect Halftime Report. Nextel, get right through.
America loves its country.
Yeah!
Get ready.
For the CMA Awards, it's country's biggest night.
Award goes to...
Celebrate the sounds of our nation. Join stars Dixie Chicks, Tim McGraw, Trisha Yearwood, Garth Brooks, and more. Vince Gill hosts...
Live from Nashville.
The CMA Awards, CBS Wednesday.
All right, guys.
This is Tim Couch of the Cleveland Browns. Tim helps the United Way build stronger communities by participating in an after-school recreational program for children.
And whatever you do, don't run.
As a quarterback, Tim is a field general.
Come on down. Wait.
Look at the command.
Oh, come on out there.
Textbook.
Oh, he's stuck. You sure? All right.
Tim Couch. Field general.
You guys listen to anything?
Now, exclusively from the NFL shop, you can customize your very own official NFL replica jersey. Pick a team, choose a number, use your name or your favorite player. It's up to you. NFL Shop will make one in any style you want, just $64.99. So call now and order for yourself or a friend. Get the gear, get in the game, exclusively from NFL Shop. Call 1-877-NFL-SHOP now or visit us at NFL Shop on NFL.com. CBS Sports presents the Nextel Direct Connect Halftime Report. Nextel, get right through.
Here in Chicago, the Browns and the Bears, a 7-7 score at halftime. In the first minute of the game, Wally Rayner's sack led to Courtney Brown's recovery and return. Anthony Thomas's touchdown in the final minute makes it a tie. More from Chicago after this from your local station.
Catch Jay Tuesday on CBS. It's all here.
Why? Season tickets.
Because we're the youngest team in the league.
And we're only going to get better.
Because I'm a true blue Bulls fan.
Because the Bulls are part of me.
Because I remember how hard it was to get a Bulls ticket.
Because it's a great way to entertain clients.
I love the Bulls.
Because we love the contest.
Because I have fun, win or lose.
Because we love the Bulls.
For season tickets, call 312-455-4000.
Because it's only a matter of time.
Introducing the new MSN from Microsoft. More useful, more advanced, and a great alternative to AOL. MSN, more useful every day.
I quit my job today.
I met this really cool guy on the internet. He's 30.
Life throws all kinds of curves. Fortunately, with its advanced safety systems, the smooth-riding RX 300 is designed to better handle the ones on the road.
Hey, Mom, you know that tattoo we talked about?
How you manage the rest is up to you. All for just $34,530. Test drive one at your Chicago area Lexus dealer.
Access denied, but I need those graphs for the meeting.
Dude, just go to Plan B.
Plan B?
What's Plan B? I don't know what Plan B is.
Tell me. What is Plan B?
As you can see from Ms. Stinsmulen and Mr. Nemely, the last couple of years were well below estimates. But this year, we expect to grow enormously. Any questions?
Reliable remote access, so you won't need a plan B. SBC Ameritech, we're on it.
What doctors fear and what you should know. Germ Warfare, Monday at 10.
As you look at the halftime numbers, you see the Chicago Bears lead just about every statistical category, but as in most games, the only numbers that count are the ones on the scoreboard. Greg Gumbel, Phil Simms back in Chicago. It has been the defensive game that we expected coming in.
Yeah, it has, Greg. I think the Chicago Bears, though, the offense found its rhythm, found out what they want to do against the Cleveland Browns defense. In the second half, though, I think Cleveland on offense has got to start throwing the ball. They got to start making some plays because to win, they're going to have to find a way to produce probably about two touchdowns.
Ready for the beginning of the second half, and the Bears will kick it away. Edinger lines it up. Benjamin Gay and Jamel White standing at their own goal line. The second half is underway. From the 13 is White. Running room on the right side. Out to the 40. And finally dragged down at about the 44 or 45 yard line. And let's go down to Armin.
Phil, it sounds like you were in the locker room with Butch Davis. He said exactly the same thing to his team. He said, we have got to find a way to generate some offense. Too many opportunities went by the wayside in the first half. And just like you said, look for Tim Couch to have a big hand in the second half. Back to you.
43-yard line is the first down. Thanks, Armin. At 4.3 average coming in was the absolute worst in the NFL, and they haven't even gotten to that so far. They'll start it off with Jackson for about 2 yards. And it'll be second and nine as the, or make it three, second and seven as the wind picks up a little bit.
Yeah, it did. It's blowing in here, Greg. But a couple things. Bruce Arians, remember when he told us last night? He says, hey, I'd like to try to make more big plays on first down, go down the field. But what stops me, he goes, we're not that good an offense, so I can't always put us in second and ten if we miss that pass. So the fact that they're a little worried about their offense hurts their creativity and their big playability, too.
Couch on second and seven, looks both ways and now throws over the middle and has his man Northcutt. And Northcutt inside the 45-yard line, that'll be a first down. And what Butch Davis readily admits is when we struggle offensively, it's our offensive line. We're not big enough to blow people off the line of scrimmage.
That's right. He'd like, he was at University of Miami for years, so he's used to getting eight yards a run. It's a little different here, but the offensive line, not the strong point for the Cleveland Browns. He knows that, so they do a lot of things to try to protect them.
First down at the 40-yard line. Here comes the blitz, but they keep it on the ground. Jackson finds running room inside 35 to the 32. Tony Parrish with the stop.
Now with Keith Traylor and Ted Washington on the inside of your defensive line, Butch Davis says last night, you know, I think we can run it up the middle. And I look at him, well, you're kidding me, right? He goes, no, I like our matchups inside. We can get those big guys moving just a little bit and cut it back up inside. And that time, James Jackson did exactly that.
That 8-yard run, Jackson's longest run today. And a second and two. Jackson again, and he tries the middle, and this time it doesn't get much as Ted Washington combines with Tony Parrish for the stop.
Well, you know, Ted Washington, I didn't even ask him his weight yesterday. We had a chance to talk to him. Number 92. You think, well, he's just a big guy. He's going to stand there and take the blocker on. But every once in a while, like that time, he's quick enough and a good enough athlete to go around the blocker and make the tackle for a short game.
And let's be honest, we don't want to say anything to offend Ted.
I was not going to ask him his weight because he is, well, he's a big human being. Even by NFL standards, he's large.
Browns just 1 out of 6 on third down today. Give it to Jackson. Jackson tries the middle, and he does not get to the 30-yard line.
Well, when you try to run straight ahead and block straight ahead against Keith Traylor and Ted Washington, they're almost impossible to move. Watch both of them, 92 and 94. Keith Traylor comes around, but Ted Washington gets underneath, pushes into the backfield, and just creates a mess. And look, oh, it makes a tackle, too. What a play. Fourth down. No doubt Cleveland is going to go for it.
Tim Couch still on the field. Butch Davis looks on. Couch gonna throw for him. Across the field, has a man wide open, and he hits number 81, Quincy Morgan, inside the 5-yard line. It's a first and goal.
I wanted to yell at you, Greg. They've run this play twice today. One coming out from the goal line. He threw it to O.J. Santiago. This time, you're going to see Quincy Morgan come across the field. There he is. Nobody on the backside. Walt Harris has him man for man. Tough to cover a wide receiver going across the field and through traffic.
Quincy Morgan, a rookie, their second-round draft choice out of Kansas State, and the Browns with first and goal.
Could it be a quarterback draw?
Couch looks both ways, throws, touchdown. Penalty marker is down. Mike Sellers made the catch.
What a drive by the Browns. Showing nothing on offense the first half. Come out in the second half, run it, play action on fourth down, and then a nice throw by Tim Couch.
Pass interference on a defensive linebacker. Penalty is declined. Touchdown.
So the touchdown goes on the board for the Cleveland Browns.
Watch Tim Couch as he drops back. He's going to get under pressure. He's going to relax and just kind of fall backwards and still make the perfect throw.
Yes.
The extra point is up and good. So the Browns took a little longer to score in the second half than it took them in the first half, but they are on the board. And now we have another discussion on the field.
Holding against Cleveland.
Holding, 78 of the kicking team, 10 yards, redo the try.
The penalty is on Tyrone Rogers. Mike Sellers with that touchdown catch. He has 24 career catches. Six of them are for touchdowns.
Well, you know, Craig, it's just amazing. Nothing in the first half, and they come out and just do a little bit of everything in that drive, and it really has to boost the confidence of the offense. Hey, the whole Cleveland Browns team.
So now, Phil Dawson lines this one up from 30 yards out. And it is good. A 7-7 tie at halftime. A drive to start things off. Couch to Mike Sellers. And it's a 14-7 lead for Butch Davis and the Cleveland Browns.
Because your toes miss the ocean. Because fall in New England only happens in New England. Because the best fishing is always the furthest away. Because your inner cowboy needs to yodel. Because babies are only babies for so long.
Shelly, listen, it's Greg. I'm at the dentist.
Yeah, okay. Shelly?
I want to come into work.
They don't know what I've got.
I have a tooth.
I got the chicken pump. Chicken pox.
24-hour, like, mumps. What else can I have?
I am really sick.
Both ears, yeah, gone.
I'm hemorrhagic.
I'm in traction.
The Acura MDX with torque managing four-wheel drive.
I was eating wax fruit this week. No.
Taking the SUV to a place it's never been before.
Lifetime television event. All new Michael Jackson special, CBS Tuesday, November 13th.
This telecast is copyrighted by the NFL for the private use of our audience. Any other use of this telecast or of any pictures, descriptions, or accounts of the game without the NFL's consent is prohibited.
Tim Couch, who says he likes this offense because it's a lot like the one he ran in college. This is a very short kick. The Bears will start from their own 32-yard line as Leon Johnson finally corrals the short kick.
They're lucky there, Greg. You know, that's something you have to work on in this league. I don't know if it was done deliberately or not, but sometimes receivers, everybody's worried about who they're going to block. Stick that hand up there and catch that football. Leon Johnson was very fortunate. He couldn't have got up there to catch it, that it just took a good bounce towards him.
So now Shane Matthews will try to jumpstart the Chicago offense, which finished on a high note at the end of the first half. And right away, Anthony Thomas will go back to work out to the 35-yard line. Let's go back to the big play that Tim Couch and the Browns offense came up with on fourth down.
Well, it's a couple things. Watch Quincy Morgan. He comes across. Tim Couch is going to look over here. If nobody's deep, that's going to be his first read. So go ahead and run the play, and they give the receiver a little running start. So now it makes it awfully hard for the defensive back to cover him all the way across the field. Quincy Morgan makes the catch. That's the exact same play coming off the goal line where Tim Couch was covered. And then he threw the long pass to the right side to O.J. Santiago.
Second and seven. Here comes the blitz. Quick pass this side. And that's complete to Marty Booker. And Booker loose football. And it bounces out of bounds. Bears catch a break.
Well, it's a blitz by the Cleveland Browns. And Corey Fuller, boy, it's a good thing he makes the tackle, knocks it out. Good job of being alert because there are no defenders behind him to help him make the tackle, and just good hustle by the Browns actually cost him that time. Was that Courtney Brown hustling over there?
I thought it might be.
I could not see the number. If that's Courtney Brown, that's impressive because he was rushing the quarterback and then got all the way to the far sideline away from him to almost recover the fumble.
First pick overall in the draft a year ago. That's Orpheus Roy, number 99, who made that play.
Yeah, and Jameer Miller, number 95, was the other one.
But you know what? Courtney Brown is still pretty impressive. Spot of the ball is going to be the 46-yard line of the Bears. So the Bears take it first and 10. Butch Davis getting an explanation on the far side of the field.
Coming back to the point of the fumble.
9:20 to play in the third quarter. Thomas.
Anthony Thomas.
For one, maybe two, we'll call it a yard in second and 9.
Second and 9, the Bears 48.
He's like a quarterback. Look to on his left arm. You can see all the defensive signals. Look at that. Haven't seen that too often from a coach. And he's pretty smart, though. Got some gloves on. He's going to stay warm while he's making those defensive calls.
Matthew throws up the seam. Has his man inside the 40-yard line. Marty Booker with the grab. 16 yards and a first down.
Now the Bears have an interesting philosophy when it comes to doing offense against the blitz. That time the Cleveland Browns blitz, instead of trying to keep people in and protect the quarterback, they just send them out sometimes. And they say, look, if you're going to send guys, you can't cover all the receivers down the field. The quarterback has to get rid of it quickly. He does that time, and Marty Booker makes a tough catch.
28 yards on receiving on this one. This one tipped and falls incomplete. And that was Courtney Brown.
I know one thing. I'd quit running that play. Because that's twice it's been hit up in the air. Those are game changers if that gets intercepted. And they do that. The Bears do that. Like some teams run reverses so a team won't over-pursue against your run game. They do that in their passing game so the defensive linemen won't rush too hard at the quarterback. They got to make them think, but the Browns are ready for it.
Thomas. Avoiding tackles inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. He'll be about 2 yards shy of a first down. It'll be third and two.
Let's see. Anthony Thomas, he's caught the football today. He's picked up a blitz a couple times. He's ran for tough yards. He's read blocks well. And now, Greg, what was left, he showed his really good feet that time, running around would-be tacklers and just picking up extra yards.
121 total yards on the day for the rookie.
I'm convinced he's pretty good.
Double tight end, third and two. Baxter in motion. Thomas trying to get to the 26-yard line, and he appears to be short.
If they don't make it, I don't think there's any doubt that they'll go for it on fourth down. With Anthony Thomas as a runner, this offensive line, not a short field goal. You got to go for it.
And they will after the measurement.
Couldn't tell if it looks like he has it or not.
Well, I already told you didn't.
Oh, you did? Okay. Well, it just goes to show you. I don't listen to you.
Noticed.
John Shute, immediately, he's already getting the play to Shane Matthews. Now, the Cleveland Browns in this situation just a few minutes ago, they went for the big play and the score. But also, the Cleveland Browns don't have the ability to run the football like the Chicago Bears do.
On fourth down, Marty Booker has come out. Number 74, Jimmy Herndon. A spare tackle has come in, and he's at the tight end position. Fourth and one. Thomas gets the first down.
Well, I tell you, fourth and inches, you can just feel the tension everywhere with the fans. I feel it. I know the coaches do. But nice job in this situation. So hard to be patient. Fred Baxter with a nice block against Dwayne Rudd. Watch number 84, gets the block. Anthony Thomas says, hey, I only need a couple inches. Gets inside to get a yard.
First down from the 29. Thomas again. Ducks inside to the 21. You know, we've talked about a little get up and go that Thomas has, but he has such power when he runs into some resistance.
Yeah, he's got that good NFL running back body that it's built for power, not too tall, so there's not a lot of target to hit for the defenders. And
well, the fans like him here, and over the years, they have seen some pretty fair running backs in the Chicago Bears uniform. Thomas again. To about the 18-and-a-half-yard line. Clock continues to move. We're under 5-and-a-half as you take a look at Anthony Thomas for his games in October.
That's pretty good.
You bet.
Boy, look what he's done today. Rushing and receiving. Now to be a great back in the NFL, you've got to be a pass receiver as well as a good runner too.
Brant Boyer, middle linebacker for Wally Reiner, third and four. Matthew looked, batted up in the air, and it's intercepted. Yes, indeed, it was intercepted. The Browns say they have it. Gerard Warren got the hand on that one. Fourth turnover of the day by the Bears. We'll be right back.
2,200 horsepower Acura RSX.
I think this photo paper is just what you're looking for.
Wow, great price.
David White, three-time employee of the month, Dan.
He has a natural ability to match a customer's needs with his budget. Really a go-to guy in these situations.
Price is right. What's the resolution?
2400 DPI.
Oh, brilliant display of team chemistry, Dan.
Yeah, Charles Rosen and Matt Herman not only have a command of the products, they anticipate exactly where the other's going to be on the floor.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Southwest Airlines, proud sponsor of the NFL and official airline of Super Bowl 36. Turning Leaf Wine, handcrafted for perfect moments. And by the all-new 200-horsepower Acura RSX Type S.
Well, one of the problems with throwing the football short and over the middle, you have to just accept this, that sometimes the ball is going to be tipped and knocked in the air because the Bears throw a lot of short passes over the middle, and what a catch by Ray Jackson. There were so many defenders for the Browns that time going for the football, I thought there's no way they're going to come up with the interception, but Ray Jackson makes a nice catch.
That ball hit Gerard Warren in the helmet and popped straight up into the air. Bear drive is halted deep. And on the right side, James Jackson, and Jackson on the move out to the 25-yard line. Mike Brown finally dragged him down.
Well, you've seen Edgerrin James run this play 1,000 times for the Indianapolis Colts. It's the stretch play. Run to the outside, run. And then you decide as a runner when to cut it back up inside. And James Jackson, terrific job that time.
So once again, the Browns escape.
Hey, their offense coming out from their own goal line is good.
Out to the 25 and a first down. Couch. On the move. And throws it away. That was one of those play fakes that we were talking about with Bruce Arians yesterday. In fact, you'll see, you were talking about Edgerrin James, you'll see Peyton Manning do that. He'll say the toughest thing in the world is to turn your back, if you're a quarterback, to the defense and trust that the blocking is getting done behind you.
Yeah, he said Tim Couch had a real problem with that at first. As a quarterback, you're always taught, watch the defense, react off what they're doing. But when you're making those play fakes, you just got to have faith in your offensive line. They're going to pick up the pass rushers. Turn your back to the defense, make them think it's a run, then try to look downfield for the big play.
And you know what? That time he turned around and saw a couple of Bears chasing him. Couch, play fake again. Throws over the middle, has his man out to the 44-yard line. That's Dennis Northcutt, and that's a first down.
Well, that's the play-action passes, Greg. That's how Cleveland can get it down the field. This allows even a pulling guard that time to make the defense think it's a run. But that's how you allow your quarterback the extra time to sit back there and read and throw the football down the field. You do it with play-action passes.
Tim Couch said during the offseason he specifically worked on play fake and ball handling.
Well, if you think coaching is not the most important thing in this league, yes, I know you need players.
Couch, gonna go deep. Johnson. Touchdown.
R.W. McQuarters got the tip on the football. Went through his hands. Kevin Johnson catches the rebound. Another fake down the field. He's looking deep. Watch to your right side. Oh, it was Mike Brown who had the tip. Mike Brown sees it, makes a good reaction, gets back.
Have we seen a season's worth of tipped passes in one night here in Soldier Field? The kick is up and good. 21-7. Browns in the lead. Kevin Johnson rejoices.
Yeah, I heard the new CRV's coming out. It has room in the back for two mountain bikes.
Well, it doesn't have to be mountain bikes. It can be anything that would be equivalent of two mountain bikes.
Really?
Like, what would you want to haul?
A pony.
Hi, I'm Susan McGinnis, news anchor for CBS Market Watch. CBS Market Watch is not only the place I work, it's also the resource I use and trust when I'm managing my own finances. It's where you should go first for the best information on mutual funds, retirement, real estate, taxes. The ING personal finance section gives you the best advice from some of the industry's most seasoned financial columnists. More than 100 journalists worldwide reporting for you. CBS Market Watch is the number one source for financial news. It's more than just news. It's news you can use.
Mr. Kenny, hi, how are you feeling? The office just got these, and I thought you could use one. It's not just a cell phone. It's Nextel with Direct Connect, a digital two-way radio. Look, you just push one button, and we're connected.
Which means you never have to leave messages. You know, like the one I left you about the elevator being out.
With ordinary cell phones, you leave messages, but with Nextel Direct Connect, you get right through.
Me and Joel are a lot like the new back seat's supposed to be.
Yeah.
We're like a 60-40 split. Look, I'm 40. You can put me down.
Right, right.
Joel stays up.
I stay up.
Or you can put me up.
And then I go down.
Access NFL.com now on America Online. Get live game day coverage and real-time stats at AOL keyword NFL.com.
Now that I'm not on the field anymore doing my thing, find out what I really have to say on NFL Today on CBS.
Kevin Johnson's 55-yard touchdown catch is his fourth straight touchdown catch in a game. The Browns with a two-touchdown lead now. Denson and Johnson are deep, and another short kick. There's a fair catch call made for at the 28-yard line. Meanwhile, on the sideline, Butch Davis once recruited Tim Couch at Miami. They're glad to be together now.
Do that?
Nah, they usually go for two.
Juice Road, validating tires.
BF Goodrich tires with traction advantage.
Approved.
For control you can feel, they can see. BF Goodrich tires, they control.
November 12th.
That's right.
Oh, yeah.
That's right.
Oh,
yeah. A new chapter will begin.
The waiting ends.
November 12th.
I know. I got what you call ants in your pants.
November 12th, baby.
Yeah, no, I really do have ants in my pants. There's a lot of ants around here.
You should get some spray.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by DirecTV, the number one digital satellite entertainment provider, and by Budweiser. With the crisp, clean, refreshing taste you'll find in no other beer.
Well, we mentioned this earlier as we welcome you back to Chicago. Tim Couch says that the big adjustment for him was the longer, more vertical game that they played his first 2 years here in Cleveland. He was happy to see Butch Davis arrive because this offense is more like the offense he played in college.
He's got a little wrap on his right hand. Either that or he's got some ice on it because it's kind of hot right now.
Just over 3 minutes of play, and the Bears go back to the ground game. And look at Thomas out across the 35 to about the 36-yard line. Let's go back to Tim Couch.
Well, you know, Greg, a couple things. Talking to Butch Davis last night, what did he say? He left Miami to come to Cleveland because, he goes, the environment, football in Cleveland, he goes, it's a religion. And then we talked about a few other things, and he goes, oh, And also, they got a quarterback, Tim Couch. He goes, that had a lot to do with my decision, because to find franchise quarterbacks or quarterback that the team and everybody believes in, they're hard to find. He knew Tim Couch was that type of quarterback, and he likes what he has seen so far this year.
Matthew, quick pass, incomplete, under pressure from Greg Spires. Fred Baxter was the intended receiver.
And, you know, even though Chicago's on offense, but one other thing about Tim Couch, I meant to say it earlier when he made that long throw and I couldn't get to it. If you think coaching is not important to players, and especially to quarterbacks, Greg, you said it, the change in offensive philosophy, it fits him. And like he said, Bruce Arians, a quarterback coach, he goes,
right.
Phil, if I make a bad throw and it gets away from me, Coach Arians can go, Tim, your foot was here, you did this wrong. And he goes, I can correct things as the game goes along.
Matthew goes down. Another sack by the Cleveland Browns. And Courtney Brown comes up with the fourth one of the day for Cleveland.
Wow, Courtney Brown. I did not think he could be that big of an impact on the game today. Up top, number 92. Just when you haven't played so long in this league, it's hard to come in and do that. But that time, good coverage down the field allowed Courtney Brown that extra second to get to Shane Matthews.
Well, all he's done today is five tackles, a couple of sacks, a fumble recovery for a touchdown. Too bad he didn't have any impact on this game. Northcutt from the 29.
Gonna look for another bonus.
And is down at the 35-yard line. 42-yard kick and a 7-yard return and a minute 43 to play in the third.
You know what I heard? The new CRV is going to have a 6-disc in-dash CD player.
No.
November 13th, after I've ridden around a lot, I'm going to load that whole thing with new age music and get full-on spiritual.
Hey, Dad, what's that?
That's a pink flamingo.
What's that?
Bullfrog.
What's that?
That, son, is a Chevy Monte Carlo.
If you want to see 700 horses under a hood, spend a day by the lake at the famous Daytona infield. But bring your Visa card, the official card of NASCAR.
Isn't nature great?
Visa, it's everywhere NASCAR fans want to be.
In and out. Good. Keep the victim calm. And one, and two, and three.
Okay, there you go. That's over 100 channels, sports, news, digital music, installation's free, and it's only $31.99 a month.
Just $31.99 a month gets you over 100 channels of DirecTV programming, right now with free professional installation.
So it was the digital music that...
Yeah.
Why do I rent from Enterprise?
For more cargo room. More people room. More headroom. Enterprise. So easy, it's like having a second car. Or third.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Tonight, the show must go on. CBS presents the 53rd Emmy Awards live. The stars will shine a little brighter as we celebrate the power of television. Root for your favorite shows and join host Ellen DeGeneres for this live TV event. The Emmy Awards. CBS Tonight.
Here's our NFL.com interactive poll for today. Who is the best kick punt returner over the last 10 years? Just a hint, it's not me. Just log on and cast your vote.
Really?
NFL.com.
Wow, what was the clue that it wasn't you?
From the 35, Couch is brought down. Roosevelt Colvin, number 59, made the sack.
I couldn't even get it out of my mouth, but if the Chicago Bears want to get back in this game, their defense is going to have to start making plays to set up its offense. And Colvin, we haven't heard from him today. You can see the speed coming off the corner. Gets to Tim Couch before he can do anything. Forcing it just to protect the football.
Now, you and I were just talking during the timeout. Tim Couch has been something of a magician when his team has been in trouble as far as field position goes. And the Bears have backed him up now to a second and 18. Much there at all. Robert Newkirk makes the initial hit. Ryan Robinson, number 98, helped.
Well, Greg, you know, the play call and a quarterback's decision here. You're up 21-7. You get sacked. Now you just got to go, let's get out of this series without making a really major mistake. Don't turn it over. Don't lose more yards. Your defense is playing well. Know when to take chances in this game. That is a major part of winning and losing.
Third and 17. Here comes the blitz. Cal, quick pass, far side. That's complete to Aaron Shea. And Shea is hit hard at about the 31-yard line. Part of that pileup is due to the fact that Aaron Shea refused to go down.
He hit hard, but you have to say hit hard many times because there were a lot of Bear defenders running to that football.
Clock is moving up on the end of the third quarter, and it appears the time will expire before.
Yeah, let it go because you're kicking into the wind. You wait till the fourth quarter, you kick downwind.
That's exactly what Gardocki and the Browns are going to do. That is the end of the third quarter with the score Cleveland 21 and the Bears 7. We'll come back to Soldier Field after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching the NFL on CBS.
An impossible mission. A massive cover-up.
We have no secrets.
It's JAG's biggest case ever.
Are you aware of the kind of trouble you're in?
All new CBS Tuesday.
Everybody Loves Raymond. Monday on CBS. It's all here.
Now get 7-year, 100,000-mile powertrain protection and 0% financing on Dodge Ram.
Yo, T!
It's good to have you back, man.
All right, listen up. Let's go get your butts on the court. Now!
Spread it out. 2-1. 2-1.
2-1. No walking, everybody move. Let's go! Hey, T, get in there. You're in. You're two guard. Go! Let's go. Let's go! Get in there and show them how to do it. Full court press. Bring it all underneath.
It's beautiful.
So are you.
Richard, the tide.
Come on, baby.
Call for help.
I'll call after 8 when my rates go down.
You better call now.
Come on, Eileen. There was a time when I couldn't get you out of the water.
With voice streams whenever minutes, you can make calls before 8 o'clock at night. Can we get some dry towels here?
3,000 whenever minutes. VoiceStream gives you the most whenever minutes, guaranteed.
Could you spot a terrorist? Tonight on the CBS 2 News at 10.
As we get ready for the fourth quarter in Chicago, a 7-7 halftime tie has now turned into a 21-7 Cleveland lead as Tim Couch has thrown touchdown passes to Mike Sellers and Kevin Johnson in the second half. And we do all this to the tune of Chicago.
I knew that.
But did you know that Chicago was first called the Chicago Transit Authority? Leon Johnson from inside his own 15. Up the middle. 30, 35. And brought down close to midfield. Dwayne Rudd made the stop.
Leon Johnson was a terrific punt returner for the New York Jets. Suffered knee injuries. And it's come back, and you can see that he is still a factor in the return. Nice move. And then he's a big, probably the biggest returner in the National Football League. So he is going to break some tackles when he runs straight ahead.
Many times a team will get a spark from special teams. The Bears are hoping so here. They have the ball at their own 49-yard line. Great field position for Shane Matthews in the offense. Thomas into Cleveland territory to about the 48 or 47-yard line, and Dwayne Rudd with the stop.
Now, if you watched the game last week or if you follow the Chicago Bears, you know, even though they get behind, last week they were down a couple touchdowns to the San Francisco 49ers. Very patient with their play calling. They will continue to run the football, try to keep situations in their favor. So when they throw it, it won't be too difficult for the quarterback or the offensive line.
You see the numbers for the Bears versus their opponents in the fourth quarter. Thomas again. Thomas breaking to the outside, turns the corner, inside the 40, inside the 35, and almost to the 30-yard line. Step stepped out of bounds back at about the 36. But he carried Anthony Henry for about 5 or 6 yards.
And you get a defense that's playing pass, trying to get after the quarterback they think. And watch Anthony Thomas when he breaks outside. Percy Ellsworth got his big arm to the face. Dwayne Rudd gets one. Two good stiff arms. There's one to the helmet. Percy Ellsworth is a big safety. Anthony Henry gets it too.
First down, Bears at the 36. Thomas inside the 35 to about the 33-yard line.
Of course, Greg, I was going to say it's easy to be patient when you're clipping off 10 and 15-yard runs sometimes in situations like this when you're behind.
Well, as we asked Butch Davis, you know, which Chicago Bears team do you prepare for? The one that was evident in the first half against the 49ers, or the one in the second? And he didn't hesitate. Oh, it was the second half team that you look for.
Well, you always prepare for the best that you see from the other team, because you figure, hey, our luck is never good. We're going to see their best plays and best effort.
On second and eight, Matthews with time down the middle of the field, incomplete. Dez White, the intended receiver, fans want a call that is not forthcoming.
No,
there's Ellsworth.
I did not see. There was a little bit of contact, not enough to really factor into the play, Greg, but it looked like, again, the football did get away from Shane Matthews just a little. It's not a big breeze, but it might be enough just to, when he lets it go, it might alter the route of the football. Watch Shane Matthews as he throws it down the field. There's Dez White coming across. Percy Ellsworth, just a little touch.
Matthews wants the flag. What he's looking at instead is a third and eight. And now timeout is called by the Bears as they use their first here in the second half. 13:01 to play in the fourth quarter. 21-7 Browns.
Where'd you learn to shoot?
Boy Scouts, sir.
Two men in a game.
Central Intelligence.
He'd be working for me, mostly undercover.
Where all they have.
God, you're hideous. Why do you even bother?
Missed you too.
Is each other.
Tom Bishop, been arrested for espionage.
I'm getting him out.
From the director of Crimson Tide and Enemy of the State.
They know.
They don't know.
They'll be waiting.
Spy Game.
Where are you?
I'm coming home.
Rated R at theaters November 21st.
You know what I expect? That the new CRV is going to have keyless entry.
Boop.
Open.
Boop.
Locked.
Boop, boop, boop.
You know what that was?
Open,
that
locked, was open, locked, open.
Open, locked, open.
Yeah. Do it again.
Boop, boop, boop.
Open, locked, open again.
No, that was locked, open, locked.
Sorry.
It's the new Ultimate Lover's Pizzas from Pizza Hut. Now with 6 kinds of luscious cheese and 6 kinds of seriously satisfying meat toppings. Or 5 garden veggies. Or 2 layers of zesty pepperoni. Just $8.99. The new Ultimate Lover's Pizzas, only from Pizza Hut.
Boys, that is the sorriest first half I've ever seen. So here's what we're going to do. First, we're going to get changed.
Change.
Then we're going to get on the bus.
The bus!
And we're going to go home.
We're going to go home.
Video game.
Loss of competitive edge. Another unfortunate side effect of hunger. Grab a Snickers, packed with peanuts, caramel, and chocolate.
Later on, we're going to take a nap.
Snickers, don't let hunger happen to you.
Hello?
Khaki.
Mr. President?
I love you.
Lyndon Johnson's secretly recorded phone calls tonight on 60 Minutes.
As we welcome you back, we remind you, for the best NFL info on the net, including expert analysis and in-depth team reports, go to cbs.sportsline.com or your AOL keyword, CBS Sportsline. Shane Matthews and the Bears at the 33, or 34-yard line, make it. Third and eight. Matthews, quick pass. That's complete. 87 is Dwayne Bates with his first catch of the day. And he'll get to the 30-yard line, and they'll be about 4 yards shy of a first down.
Too far to kick a field goal. You go for it on fourth down. I think that was the Chicago Bears thinking as they were coming out of that timeout. Run a pretty safe play. Play action. We don't get it. We'll go for it on fourth.
Plus, he'd be kicking into the wind here. Bears need the 26-yard line for a first down. Matthews is buried back at the 41. guess who was in on Shane Matthews? Courtney Brown. The young man has had an impact on this football game tonight.
Filtered for when you feel the heat. Get refreshment down cold. Cold filtered Miller Genuine Draft.
My name's John Woolard. I rescue alligators for a living.
John Woolard is one brave guy.
It's pretty exciting.
But would John Woolard ever get car insurance that didn't come with a State Farm agent?
Car insurance with no State Farm agent? I'm not that brave.
When it comes to car insurance, why take a chance? Be like this State Farm customer and get an agent you can rely on, plus competitive rates.
Go on now.
I read on a message board, they think the new CRV is going to have like a new iVTEC engine.
What does that stand for?
Well, it's pretty technical.
It's intelligent variable timing and lift electronic control.
Is your dandruff sending the wrong signals?
Go!
No.
Get Celsin Power. Doctors recommend Celsin Blue.
Man, that dude's awesome.
Get Celsin Power.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by cold-filtered Miller Genuine Draft. Never miss a genuine opportunity. State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And by Snickers. Don't let hunger happen to you.
12 minutes, 17 seconds left in the fourth quarter as Tim Couch and the Browns take over at the 40-yard line.
Now it's going to be hard for the Bears defense to come up with a turnover, because I'm sure the running backs are thinking, hold on to the football.
Jackson with room to run up the middle out to the 46-yard line. Brian Urlacher. As we told you earlier, Courtney Brown, a Penn State record, 33 sacks. And boy, has he turned in a performance here today. Picks up the loose ball. And then has leveled Shane Matthews with three sacks. Chicago has turned the ball over five times tonight. Two Matthews fumbles, three interceptions.
And we're just going to spot playing today, they said. Of course, he goes out there and gets a sack. All of a sudden, you say, hey, we need to play Courtney more.
Jackson hesitates and then busts it up to the 49-yard line. And let's check into New York once again for an NFL Today update.
All right, Greg, Chargers trying to get back into it. Tomlinson's been held in check most of the way. 12 carries, 30 yards, and this touchdown. The star so far has been the Chiefs. Priest Holmes, 127 on the ground. KC up 9. They're about to start the fourth. Back to you.
All right, Jim, thank you. Just when you think you have things figured out in this league and the San Diego Chargers are really rolling, the Kansas City Chiefs say, no, you're not. Third and one. The Bears could use a stop here, to say the least. Couch going to throw for it. Quick pass out here, and Sellers wasn't looking. Sellers was turning it upfield, and the ball floated behind him, and the Browns punting unit will take the field.
Yeah, Tim Couch thought it was going to be an immediate throw to Sellers, and Sellers was going to fake it and run up the sideline, look for a big play.
So Leon Johnson back once again, turned in a big return the last time he got his hands on the ball. Gardocki.
Beautiful.
This one's going to roll into the end zone for the touchback. 51-yard punt. Bears at the 20 when we come back.
In and out.
Good.
Keep the victim calm.
And one and two and three. And
okay, there you go. That's over 100 channels, sports, news, digital music. Installation's free, and it's only $31.99 a month.
Just
Just $31.99 a month gets you over 100 channels of DirecTV programming. Right now with free professional installation.
So it was the digital music that...
Yeah.
Drink responsibly.
See why The Guardian is TV's most watched new drama. Attorney Nick Fallon once got busted for drugs. Now, someone is trying to tempt him into making the biggest mistake of his life.
I thought I'd never see you again.
This Tuesday, one lawyer will face his demons.
I could lose the firm. You could lose your job.
All new Guardian CBS Tuesday.
Back in 1994, the Cleveland Browns began the season 6-1. That's the last time they were divisional leaders. Should they hold on to this lead, they will tie the Steelers atop the AFC Central. And about the game set up next week in Cleveland as the Pittsburgh Steelers move in, that'll be one of the games on CBS. The NFL Today leads things off at noon Eastern time. Be some head knocking there. First down for the Bears, their own 20-yard line. Matthews goes to work through the air, up the middle, incomplete, and a penalty marker is down.
Could be a personal foul. Yes, it is, against Gerard Warren, 94.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness. On the defense, roughing the passer, taking him to the ground and burying him. 15 yards, first down.
Let's watch 94. Gerard Warren in the middle, just getting a good push. Well, you know, I couldn't quite hear what Jerry Austin said, but you cannot take the quarterback to the ground and lay your body weight on top of him like that. You can take him down and fall there, but if you pick your body up and fall on top of the quarterback, that is a personal foul.
That is the second personal foul on the Browns. The right side. Cuts it back inside. Another marker flies. Another marker flies, and Dwayne Rudd says this is holding against the Bears. And he's right.
Holding, 71 offense, 10 yards, repeat first down.
James Williams, the right tackle, guilty of the hold, and so Gerald Austin giveth and he taketh away.
Oh, you're so smooth. What's interesting, though, Greg, like we said earlier, there's still 10 minutes, 23 seconds to go. The Bears still willing to run the football. No use. They are not going to panic yet. They don't have to.
Play fake. Matthew pulls up, throws, this time hits his man. Marty Booker holds the football and goes down, and Matthews gets off the turf. Back into the backfield. But what a grab and hold by Marty Booker.
And Devin Bush, number 23, is the one that hits Marty Booker. Watch this throw into such tight coverage. Devin Bush gets him, and Shane Matthews, Jameer Miller that time on the hit, is going to the ground more today than he has as a Chicago Bear quarterback this year.
Second and five. Thomas up the middle for three. And Shane Matthews was telling us, you know, this has not been a rough, an easy road for him physically. He has had his share of physical problems, and, you know, it goes further back than when he was knocked out at the beginning of the season.
Well, he's had a lot of problems. First thing he says, he walks into the room, he goes, look at me. Then I look at him, he goes, this is as big as I've been in my whole NFL career. And I said, how much do you weigh? He was hedging. He says, I weigh 200 pounds. So, but he has had a lot of physical ailments and overcome them. And I think that's one of the reasons why he's so calm about his play.
He stands in there and throws a strike down the middle of the field to David Terrell. And that'll be enough for a first down. And we check in with Armin.
Guys, you mentioned those physical ailments, and we all sat there kind of in shock when Shane told us about back in January of 2000 when he went in for this routine sports hernia operation that went terribly wrong, ended up with an infection, several surgeries, resulted in this huge open wound the size of a softball in his chest, 4.5 months on his back, around-the-clock IVs, finally recovers. He told us, I didn't really care if I ever played again. I just wanted to get healthy. Greg?
Hey, Armin, thank you. Matthews play fakes and throws to the near side, and that's complete. Anthony Thomas out of the backfield with the catch. You know, Shane was telling us, you know, he's had that gaping hole in his abdominal area, and his wife had to help him. Nurses were coming to the house, and as Armin said, he said he really didn't know or care if he ever played football again at that point.
That's right. He was on constant IVs, Greg. He had a permanent one put into his arm, and it's, gosh, when I sit there and listen to it, it is amazing that he hung in there and is able to come back and still be a quarterback in this league.
James Allen on the carry, and there's a penalty markers down all over the field.
Allen carry, there are three flags on the play.
Too many players on the field, maybe?
12 men on defense, 5 yards, repeat second down.
Well, let's see if we can pick up 12. There's 4 in a defensive line. That's 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Somebody show me 12.
Maybe there's 5 on the
defensive
line.
I'm sorry. There's 2 linebackers standing near each other. Ah, but I caught them.
I'm here to back you up. You know my mathematical abilities.
4 linemen, 4 linebackers, and 4 defensive backs.
Straight ahead, Thomas, after a breather on the sideline, gets inside the 35 to the 33-yard line. Clock continues to move, coming up on 7 minutes to play here in the fourth quarter.
Well, as John Shoup, he told us, Greg, we talked about this situation. He just tells his offense and his quarterback, look, he wants him, hey, get him out of the huddle and let's get going.
And now penalty marker flies, and you saw John Shoup yelling.
Illegal substitution. Legal substitution on the offense. 12 men in the huddle at the same time. 5 yards. It's still first down.
And John Shoup voices his disapproval.
Yes. 12 people in the huddle. You cannot do that. That is confusing to the defense. But John Shoup, what I was going to say, Greg, he knows, he tells his offense and his quarterback, we just take your time. Let's make sure we make the right plays to score the first touchdown. Don't be in a rush and ruin what we're trying to do right now.
First and 15. Play fake. Matthews. Pass is batted out of the air, incomplete. He was looking at Thomas coming out of the backfield, and Mark Smith appeared to be the man who got a hand up to knock that one down.
Second and 15 at the 38.
Nobody was open down the field. Shane Matthews looking for the back out of the backfield, and a lot of these today. And of course, that had to be part of the game plan for the Cleveland Browns. The Bears take short drops. They throw short passes. Be looking. If you can't get to the quarterback, watch, raise your arms up and see if you can knock the ball down.
Second and 15. And whistles blow. And this looks like this will be a false start against the Bears.
And another tip pass.
Prior to the snap, false start, 64. 5 yards, it's still second down.
Left guard Rex Tucker. So 5 penalties on this drive, 3 by the Bears. And the Bears are heading the wrong direction. They're back to the Cleveland 43-yard line, and it's second and 20.
It's a lot. Play left, do some right.
Thomas. Bears were hoping he could pop a long one, but that hole closed quickly, courtesy of Jameer Miller.
Well, it was close to pop, and it could have been a big game, but Jameer Miller was just so aggressive coming towards the line of scrimmage and just runs right into the running back. I don't think there were any Cleveland defenders thinking about the running game on that play. It was a good call, but Jameer Miller just happened to make a really good play.
Third and 20.
Right beside you. Right beside you.
Matthews over the middle, and that's batted and falls incomplete. Courtney Brown.
Boy, it's incredible. And I just said it a minute ago, Greg, but there is no doubt in my mind this was talked a lot by the Cleveland Browns defenders. When you look at films and you watch this Bears offense, a lot of short passes over the middle. Those are the ones you think you have the best chance to knock down, and they have deflected quite a few today.
You know, Phil, we didn't realize it when this game began, but the really good news for Cleveland Browns fans is Courtney Brown is back and healthy. Fourth and 20. Matthew's going to go deep down the sideline. Des White, his intended receiver, it's incomplete inside the five. Anthony Henry was with him stride for stride.
I can't believe they left a one-on-one on third and 20.
5:39 to play in the fourth. Cleveland takes over on downs.
This way. You're not going to believe this.
What was stolen?
Everything. Payroll, R&D, customer records, all the assets.
How could they get everything?
I don't know. You're the cops.
The room is completely empty. All the assets were in this room?
Everything. Ned, the servers, they stole all our servers.
No, we moved everything onto that one. It's going to save us a bundle. I sent out an email.
IBM E-Servers running Linux.
What's a server?
They can save you a bundle.
When it comes to food, a lot of places have silly ideas to bring you in. But once you get to the taste, where's the fresh? Hey, Clucky, want something made fresh?
Uh-huh.
Come on. Try one of the new Subway Selects made on fresh-baked gourmet bread. Susie?
Right, Tim. Subway's got four new Subway Selects, like the delicious horseradish steak and cheese, all on fresh-baked gourmet bread and all made fresh right in front of you.
Whoa, check out that check.
Subway.
Just kidding.
Neglecting your retirement plan? Sun America can help. Just ask your financial advisor. Sun America, the retirement specialist.
Swordfish. Buy it on video.
Best crackers in the world. You can do this in 60 minutes.
Get the password.
I need in 60 seconds.
To action.
Three.
More time. More
two,
time.
One.
Not everything ends the way you think it should.
Swordfish. Buy it on video cassette and DVD.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by IBM. Taking e-business and your business to the next level. And by Subway. Fresh-made sandwiches on fresh-baked bread. Subway. Eat fresh.
Welcome back to Chicago. Courtney Brown, a defensive standout today for the Cleveland Browns.
Now we know why Jameer Miller said to us, you mean the machine.
The machine.
And we understand why. He is physically superior to a lot of people in this league.
In the Chicago Bear territory is James Jackson. If you're looking for a turning point of this game, in the third quarter with the score tied at 7 on a 4th and 1, Couch hit Quincy Morgan with a 28-yard pass that kept the drive alive, and they scored from there and built to a 2-touchdown lead.
You know, Greg, but I got to go back and talk about Courtney Brown. You know how you become the first pick of the NFL draft? You have a really productive college career, which he did at Penn State, but then you've got to test or show that you have this unusual physical abilities, 6'4", 280 pounds, and runs a 4.5 or faster 40-yard dash. You've got a chance to be an outstanding player with those qualities.
Jackson going to reverse his field and try the left side, turn in the corner, and inside the 35, and the marker is down. This could be a block from behind.
There's a flag in the play.
J. Gerald Austin with a running discussion with Brian Robinson of the Bears.
Oh, I'm just watching everything. I see Cleveland Brown players mad. I see their coaches mad. I figured it was holding against the Browns.
Illegal block from behind. Number 81 of the offense. 10 yards. Repeat first down.
Quincy Morgan, the guilty party. And Coach Davis talking to him about it. You know, one more thing about Courtney Brown, and it's worth going back to. We said it earlier. He told us the tough thing for him today would be getting back to game speed. I sure hope I don't read anywhere after the game that he says he still has a little further to go.
Yeah. Well, he showed a couple things, Greg. The knee injury, but not playing, getting his legs strong. He probably is a little faster than most of the players out there just because he is fresh, and he's been training so hard just getting ready for this moment.
Of course, on the negative side for Butch Davis and Coach Fazio, they lost Keith McKenzie with a fractured ankle. His return, Courtney's, all that much more important. First and 13. And Jackson to about the 48.
But I really like the way the Cleveland Browns played this game today. Their defense, we've watched it. It's aggressive. It makes plays. Courtney Brown, they got some really outstanding defensive linemen who can put pressure on the opposing quarterback. The secondary, they keep coming up with interceptions. But in offense, they run the football. It's a pretty simple game plan. When they do throw the play actions, they look for the big yardage. And when they did today, they missed, a couple in the first half. But in the second half, the play action game was just incredible. And Tim Couch does not resemble the quarterback we saw the first 2 years.
Keep it on the ground again. And Jackson is pulled down. And that defense has been superb. Hands in the air. They have this evening, and there are all kinds of penalty markers.
We got a lot of them going on, and it's
just as things have gotten chippy on the field.
This might take them 20 minutes to figure out who was all the fights were. But, you know, I want to just finish what I was saying, Craig, about Tim Couch. Personal foul against the Bears.
Personal foul, 53 offense, 15 yards, first down.
That is on Warwick Holdman, the linebacker.
But to go back to Tim, of course Tim Couch doesn't look like the quarterback. Experience has really helped him. But what I just noticed a difference in, just physically, just so much better than he was the first 2 years. Throwing the football crisper, more accurately, and Butch Davis is right. Good reason to come to Cleveland.
For those of you expecting to see 60 Minutes, you're watching the NFL on CBS in the game between the Browns and the Bears. Greg Gumbel, Phil Sims, Armin Katayan, our score. The Browns leading Chicago 21-7. We remind you, 60 Minutes will be seen in its entirety immediately after this game, except on the West Coast. First down for the Bears, or for the Browns, and the pitch to James Jackson, and he's brought down short of the 35-yard line. What's going on in this game today? Turnovers have been the story. Early on in this game, first minute, Wally Rayner charged, caused the fumble. Courtney Brown returned it. One interception. Two interceptions. Three interceptions by the Cleveland Browns. And then, in fact, for that Cleveland defense, they've had more batted balls than the Yankees did in a couple of games earlier this week.
Ooh.
You know I'm right.
Yeah, you are right.
Second and 13. Jackson again. Jackson becomes the workhorse to try to take time off of the clock, which is now under 3 minutes.
You know, too, Greg, the Chicago Bear defense, it's played well today. It did a lot of nice things. It didn't give up any yards in the first half at all to the Cleveland Browns, but the Bears offense, it just continues just turning the football over, put the team in such terrible position that they weren't able to overcome it.
Meanwhile, how about cause for celebration in Cleveland, where the Browns will go home tonight, co-owners of the top spot in the AFC Central and a chance to grab it outright next week against Pittsburgh.
I like what Tim Couch was talking about. I said, hey, you know, how were those first 2 years in Cleveland for you?
Penalty markers fly.
what he was talking about.
Prior to the snap, delay of gain, offense, 5 yards. It's still third down.
He was talking about, Greg, the criticism. You know, a lot of times you come in to be a professional athlete, especially a quarterback, you know, it changes. The game changes. When you don't win, you're going to take some criticism. And he goes, man, it's like I was being criticized for being the first pick of the NFL draft or being, you know, well.
But this is a young guy. This is a young guy who has never had to deal with criticism. He was always at or near the top in his high school career and in his college career. Third and 15. And they're going to keep it on the ground again. And you know, it's really interesting. He made a very good point, and he wasn't whining, but he said, Dante Culpepper comes into the league, and he's got Randy Moss and Chris Carter catching his passes. Right. We come up on 2 minutes to play here at Soldier Field. The Browns in control by 2 touchdowns.
Mr. Kenny, hi, how are you feeling? The office just got these, and I thought you could use one. It's not just a cell phone. It's Nextel with Direct Connect, a digital two-way radio. Look, you just push one button, and we're connected.
Which means you never have to leave messages. You know, like the one I left you about the elevator being out.
With ordinary cell phones, you leave messages, but with Nextel Direct Connect, you get right through.
You're nobody till somebody loves you. You're nobody till somebody cares. You may be king, you may possess the world and its gold, but gold won't bring you happiness.
I'd like to take a look at my investments.
Can Fidelity help me with some planning? Go through what I'm invested in, goals and so forth?
Of course. You know, now might be a good time to look at your entire portfolio.
Yeah, you can help.
Well, certainly. With Fidelity Portfolio Review, we can help you draw a complete picture.
Really?
Sure. Fidelity and non-Fidelity accounts, IRAs, 401k, stocks, mutual funds, even the effects of taxes.
How do we start?
Well, we meet in person or over the phone.
That's great. Let's get rolling.
For a free review of your portfolio, call 1-800-FIDELITY.
Even if you've watched... Every alliance will be shattered.
Oh, my God.
The survivors thought they knew the game, but the game has changed forever. Don't miss the first 15 minutes of an all-new Survivor, CBS Thursday.
As we welcome you back to Chicago, Cleveland and the Bears, two teams that haven't seen a lot of airtime nationally because of the recent seasons that they've had. And people might think they've been a little bit of a fluke. They're not flukes.
No, neither team is. The Cleveland Browns have shown today that they can do a lot of good things on the football field. Yes, it's been a rough day for the Chicago Bears, but I have no doubt they're going to hang in this and be a factor and get into the playoffs when the end of the year comes.
And that punt sails into the end zone, and so the ball will come out to the 20-yard line. And while we have the opportunity, we'll remind you, coming up on CBS, 60 Minutes, and then the 53rd Annual Emmy Awards, twice postponed, but coming your way this evening on CBS. A minute 52 to play here in the fourth quarter.
Now, Greg, as you look at this, do you think, and, you know, the Bears, that do you think they were a fluke coming in, what we saw when we were getting ready this week at 5-1?
Oh, no. Film, as you're happy to say, film doesn't lie.
It doesn't lie, and I think you can just tell the defense is good. The offense, yes, it had a rough day, but they have a lot of talent on offense. The running back, they got good wide receivers, a good tight end. The quarterbacks have played well.
Matthews to James Allen, and Allen out of bounds just across the 20-yard line. And that's a pickup of just one. It's 2nd and 9.
But as we've seen, even teams that we all thought were going to be in the playoffs and go to the Super Bowl and all that, they're struggling. Most of them would love to have a 5-2 record right now. Tennessee Titans, they're one. They pull out a big victory again today. The Baltimore Ravens, they struggle every week to try to find a way to win. So you can't let one loss get you down. You got to look at the big picture.
Matthew steps up, throws far side, and that is incomplete. caught out of bounds by Marty Booker. There's Brian Urlacher.
Well, we didn't get a chance to talk about him too much today. Brian Urlacher actually said to us, he goes, you know, I'm not making as many plays this year as I have in the past, but you know what? That's a good sign. That means there are better players with you, and you're not always the one, you know, picking up for the bad play of some of your defensive teammates. The linebackers are good. Ted Washington comes here, helps out the defensive line, along with Keith Traylor.
And that play is being reviewed on the sideline, and this is not a challenge by Dick Geron. This is an automatic inside of 2 minutes. And they are going to check to see if he was inbounds or not. Let's take a look.
Let's take a look. Marty Booker to the right side. That's a really nice throw by Shane Matthews. Just gets in there.
You know, I call that a catch.
You do.
Legitimate catch.
Yes. His right foot was dragging, Greg, as he was catching. Watch his right foot. It's on the ground.
Left foot is down. Right foot is dragging. That's a completion.
It is.
While we have a moment, we'll tell you the executive producers of the NFL on CBS are Sean McManus and Terry Ewert. Coordinating director of the NFL on CBS is Larry Cavallina. Producer of today's game is Mark Wolf. Senior producer of the NFL today is Eric Mann, and the director, Bob Matina. Coordinating producer of CBS Sports is Harold Bryant. The associate directors of today's game, Ross Schneiderman and Steve Karasik. Our broadcast associates, Ryan Galvin and John Paquette. Our technical manager, Pete Kalander. Our technical director, Scott Sickler. Our audio supervisor is Phil Adler, and our production manager is Rainey McHenry. And the rest of our ace CBS crew.
The player controls the ball, gets 1 foot down, and then drags the second foot. That makes it a completion. First and 10 at the 35.
Very nice. The line of scrimmage will move up. Well reviewed and well explained by Jerry Austin. Meanwhile, on the other side, if the Bears are looking for a bright spot, it's the continued outstanding performance of Anthony Thomas, who had 167 total yards today. Matthews going to come this way. And that's a juggling catch and out of bounds at the 47-yard line by Dez White.
I think he got control of him before he did go out of bounds. If there's any question, we'll have us a review.
Yes, that's right.
Well, it's just an amazing league. Dick Geron, the Chicago Bears, we spent Friday with them. They were feeling so good about their football team, about this game. Nice week of preparation.
Pass underneath, complete to David Terrell. And Terrell inside the 45, and the clock continues to move.
And then you go, where did he go wrong? What did Dick Geron say to us on Friday? He goes, I don't know how to judge it. Does it, if you have a good week of practice, does it mean anything when the game starts and it goes along? I don't know.
Throw far side, and that's complete to James Allen. And Allen inside the 30. And we welcome those of you who watch the Washington Redskins defeat the Seattle Seahawks. Greg Gumbel, Phil Simms, Armin Katayan at Soldier Field in Chicago. The Bears have called a timeout to stop the clock with a minute and 2 seconds remaining. They have one left. They are down 21-7, and it has been a day of terrific defensive play by the Cleveland Browns.
That it has, and let's don't give up too quick yet. There's still a minute to go. We know better.
Yes, we do. The
you look for the score somewhere. It's, of course, as quick as you can get it, you'd like to, but then it's the onside kick and you get a couple shots at the end zone.
Here's what's happened. We'll bring you up to date on the action here today at Soldier Field. Loose football picked up by the Browns. Number 92 is Courtney Brown. Looks both ways, throws, touchdown. Couch, gonna go deep. Caught, Kevin Johnson. And back to live action now. The pass to the sideline is complete inside the 15-yard line to Dez White, who made a terrific grab of a high pass. And that's a first down at the 14-yard line, and the Browns line up quickly. Number 96, Greg Spires, limping off the field and didn't get off the field in time. He did not get on the field in time, and now the flags fall on the far side. You know, the way Greg Spires got off the field, I'm surprised he made it off at all. Well, if he was replaced on the field, that'll be too many men. If he wasn't, he was offside.
That's right.
Illegal substitution on the defense, 12 men on the field, 5 yards, still first down.
Almost seems unfair when a guy is trying to figure out what day it is.
Nothing's unfair in this league, Greg. It's just the way it is.
By the way, a day late, but just as sincere, a happy birthday to my partner, Phil Sims.
Thank you, Greg.
Cake was good, wasn't it?
A present would have been better.
You'll have to settle for cake.
Okay.
We remind you, 60 Minutes comes your way next, except on the West Coast. And it appears we're going to have a review of that last catch. Here's the juggling catch on the sideline by Dez White.
Control. They did not rule that he was forced out. If you rule that he is forced out by the hit, you think he's going to land in bounds, then it's not reviewable. Now, both of his feet do come down in bounds, but it's, if we run that back one more time,
The question is whether or not his right foot, if he had control when his right foot came down.
His feet do come down, but watch. It's the other angle. His right hand is out of bounds before his left foot hits the ground. This angle shows it all to you. Watch. Boy, what a leap by Dez White. Left foot, real close. So, boy.
I'm going to let you call this one, Phil, since it was your birthday and all.
Yeah, thank you, baby. I can change my opinion as fast as anybody I've ever known. Every time I watch a replay, I go, yes, no.
Yes.
But that was so close that maybe it's going to have to stay.
One of the great lines is, I feel strongly both ways. Here's Jerry Austin.
Replay. Call to challenge a play of the catch on the sideline. However, we ran a play, and since the play was run, the previous play cannot be challenged. So the call stands. It's first down due to the substitution foul. First down and 5.
Shane Matthews spiked the ball on the snap, and a play was run.
Well, you know, that's right. Even though there was a penalty, I thought, well, that's what overruled it. The play didn't count because of the penalty, but it did count. The play was run. So it's not a reviewable play, and if it was, even if you would have reviewed it, I think it would, the play would have stood anyway.
But what made the fact that the play was run off, because had they not snapped the ball, then the extra man on the field would not have been a penalty.
That's right. And they still have not marked off the penalty, I don't think, either, Greg. Now we're going to mark it off.
If you're just joining us, we welcome you to the longest 36 seconds remaining in a football game in history.
There we go.
No, I moved the ball from back there.
So the line of scrimmage now just inside the 10-yard line, and it's a 1st and 5 for the Bears. 36 seconds to play, and we're not going to get started just yet, because somebody else has an opinion to voice.
Here we go.
Here we go. Bears hoping for the touchdown and then the onside kick. From the shotgun, Matthews throws, end zone. Incomplete. Fred Baxter, his intended receiver.
Grant Boyer, number 52, got his hands on the football again. He's made one interception today. Look to the right of your screen.
Catchable ball.
Yes, and Grant Boyer did not get his hands on the football. Right through the arms of Fred Baxter.
Shane Matthews, a career-high 296 yards today. Just 7 points to show for it on the board. Second and five. Again, touchdown. Marty Booker. The 9-yard catch, and now the extra point to pull the Bears to within a touchdown.
Nice throw by Shane Matthews. The Bears go out at three receivers. The bunch that causes confusion, it leaves Marty Booker wide open in the end zone.
Edinger for the extra point, and it is good. 28 seconds remaining to be played. And we see teams practicing the onside kick every single week at practice.
But one thing you notice that all the time, the kickers love to kick it down into the ground to make the football pop right up. That's Mike Swetman, the special teams coach. He was a special teams coach when I was at the Giants. He had the kickers working on that constantly. Every single day they would work on the onside kick because it can be the difference in one or two games a year. But on grass, in November, in Chicago, can you make it pop up?
You just like concrete.
Well, there you go.
Actually, it hasn't been that cold. We remind you tonight on CBS, once we wind down, except on the West Coast, 60 Minutes. And then the 53rd Annual Emmy Awards come your way. That's live tonight on CBS. Onside kick coming. The Browns with 7 players on the near side of the field. Get a bounce. Oh, there's a high hop. It is a pile up inside midfield. Let's see who comes up with the football.
Well, there was the hop we were talking about, Greg. It came. It was on the second hop. Usually it's one bounce and it goes up.
Mike Sellers says the Browns have it. Bears say they have it.
Watch the kick. Boom, 1-2, and after this one, it just goes straight up.
And they are still trying to unstack the players to make a call.
I couldn't see who for Chicago really made a nice play keeping the ball in bounds. I think it was Jerry Azuma.
We're still waiting for a call. Bears ball.
Watch the ball. It does not take a good hop, so no Brown defender can come up and catch it. Now it goes in the air. Percy Ellsworth hits it. Jerry Azuma knocks it out of the hands.
And number 52 jumping on the pile is Bobbie Howard, a first-year linebacker.
The Bears have one timeout.
The line of scrimmage will be the 47-yard line of the Cleveland Browns. Shane Matthews and the offense come back on the field.
Not only do they recover the football, but it's about 15 yards farther up the field than it normally would be on an onside kick because it took the extra hop and went about 5 more yards in the air.
Shane Matthews, a career-high 305 yards passing, looking to add to that. 24 seconds to play. The Bears with one timeout. Underneath. Complete. James Allen. Allen looking for the sideline. and is out of bounds at about the 43.
Oh, they had a chance that time. Fred Baxter was running up the field one-on-one with nobody behind, and it looked like a chance that maybe Shane Matthews, you got to look down the field. You're going to get three plays max, probably two.
Bears tied the 49ers late last week, won it in overtime.
And the way you line up will determine now that now Cleveland's going to play a much better defense, more conservative.
Matthew, short flip to Allen. Allen cuts it inside, down at the 33-yard line. And the clock is stopped with 8 seconds to play as the Bears use their final timeout.
That's a much better defensive call than the first one by the Browns. Too aggressive on the first one. This time, now, Shane Matthews has just got to make sure whatever the play is called, that he buys a little extra time, let your receivers get in the end zone, get set up, and you create the jump ball situation.
So the Browns with a 2-touchdown lead up until moments ago, and now trying to hold on and go back to Cleveland with a share of the top spot in the AFC Central. Been a good football game.
It has been a good football. Yes, it has. You didn't think it was going to come down to this, though, did you?
No, I didn't.
But the Bears did the right thing. They took their time and finally scored that touchdown. And they got extremely fortunate, of course, to get the onside kick.
Bears are out of timeouts.
You got to take your time.
Steps up, going to go for it all in the end zone. Jump ball. Caught. It's caught. James Allen was there for the tip.
Shane Matthews stepping up in the pocket allowed the receivers to get in the end zone, create the tip for the catch by James Allen.
Hey, baby! That's not what he would.
We have a player down in the far corner of the end zone as you take one more look.
That is perfect execution. Three receivers jump, tip it in the air. Somebody trails the pack of receivers. That's how you teach it. Somebody has got to come in, the secondary person, James Allen. What a catch.
He fell on Marty Booker. As the Bears score their second touchdown in 32 seconds.
Boy, now emotionally, the Cleveland Browns, they were on the sideline congratulating each other. They have shut it down, and it's such a tough thing to do to reload and to come back and try to create some offense to win a game.
And that is Booker. Allen made the grab, flipped over to protect the football, and landed on his teammate, who has now helped to his feet.
But Greg, we talked about the one thing that the quarterback has to do in situations like this. You just can't drop back and throw the football in rhythm. You've got to give your receivers an extra second or two. Shane Matthews did it, stepped up in the pocket, and let three receivers get in the end zone for the deflection.
James Allen, 65 yards receiving in the last 2 minutes. Ettinger for the tie. The clock reads 00, and we are tied at 21.
Let's see who tips the football. David Terrell. Really, it's the Cleveland Browns who knock it up in the air. The one thing on defense that you've got to try to do, don't go for the tip. Try to hit the ball downward. Nobody did that time. All the hands, and why are all the hands there? Because they had time to get in the end zone to give the Chicago Bears a chance for this play.
Shane Matthews with 29 of 48 for 352 yards. Each of those numbers is a career high.
And then that's
heads. And we'll have a coin toss at center field.
What's your call? Heads is a call. It's a tail.
We want the ball.
We'll kick that way.
The Bears get the football. The Browns will kick with the wind. We'll come back with overtime right after this.
Change for a dollar.
Sure.
Introducing the all-new Chevy Avalanche. The only vehicle that changes from an SUV to a pickup.
Thanks.
Chevy Avalanche. Like a rock.
In and out.
Good.
Keep the victim calm.
And one and two and three.
Okay, there you go. That's over 100 channels, sports, news, digital music, installation's free, and it's only $31.99 a month.
Just $31.99 a month gets you over 100 channels of DirecTV programming, right now with free professional installation.
So it was the digital music that...
Yeah.
Yeah.
America's best night of comedy is CBS Monday. First, a hospital visit brings Doug face-to-face with the world's most annoying patient.
Ho! Ho!
The King of Queens. Then is Greg a bad dad?
You set the bar so low I can do the bare minimum and feel like the world's greatest dad.
And you're welcome.
Yes, dear. Next, Ray's wife and mom team up on a devious plan.
It's like voodoo.
And Dr. Becker's not afraid of modern medicine.
Get me out of here!
All new comedy, CBS Monday.
Time permitting, 60 minutes will come your way after this game, and then the 53rd annual Emmy Awards coming your way tonight on CBS. Just last week against the 49ers, they went to overtime. First play of the OT, Jeff Garcia's pass through the arms of Terrell Owens, picked off by Mike Brown, who returned for the touchdown, and the shortest overtime in NFL history. And here the Bears are. They find themselves in an overtime once again, this time against the Cleveland Browns. And what a night Shane Matthews has had. Matthews, 155 yards passing in the fourth quarter alone. And two touchdowns. Autry Denson, Leon Johnson are deep. Johnson from the two. 25, 32-yard line. That's where Matthews and company will go to work. Each team gets two timeouts in overtime. Phil, you said, don't give up on the team late in the game because most anything can happen. It did.
I don't know if I meant it, but... Greg, you watch these games enough. If you give professional athletes like this just one chance, sometimes they're able to come up with the plays. The onside kick, the long pass, two incredible plays.
Those of you who watch San Diego and Kansas City, welcome to Soldier Field in Chicago, where we are underway in overtime. That man, James Allen, caught the Hail Mary in the end zone with no time left on the clock to send this game to overtime at 21.
And before that, the Bears recovered an onside kick, completed two passes to set up the Hail Mary.
Second and seven. Matthews, play fake.
Wide open.
Pulls it down and now throws it away. Let's go back to the play that ended regulation time.
David Terrell, number 83, Marty Booker, 86, and also Percy Ellsworth for the Cleveland Browns. Knock it up in the air. James Allen comes up with the catch. Well, that first play, Greg, though, Dez White was wide open. I do not know why Shane Matthews did not throw it to him. He might have been looking inside instead of outside. But Dez White had his defender beat by 5 yards for about a 15-yard gain.
third and 7. Over the middle. That's complete. And this is White, and White is short of a first down at the 40-yard line. So that will bring Brad Maynard and the punting unit onto the field.
Well, they couldn't take advantage. The Chicago Bear offense had the Cleveland Browns defense reeling, but the Browns, hey, that is a terrific job, just stopping momentum, stopping their offense, and getting off the field.
Dennis Northcutt is deep for the Browns.
They're going to force what this does, driving them back like this with the punt. It will force the Cleveland Browns to be aggressive in what they try to do on offense this series.
Now, Tim Couch has been good tonight. 13 of 21 for 195 and 2 touchdowns. He has been particularly good deep in his own territory on third down and even on fourth down to get his team out of trouble.
I would think the Browns will come out with some type of play action and look to pick up big yards on the first play here.
Play action it is.
Got him wide open.
He's got him over the middle, and that's complete to Kevin Johnson. He's out of bounds across the 25 to about the 28-yard line.
As soon as I saw Kevin Johnson come in motion, I knew it was going to be the play action pass, because what that does, when that receiver comes in motion, that makes it so hard. Again, I said this earlier, a defender covering man-to-man has to chase him across the formation and has to see if it's a pass or a run. It's just too much.
How about the way Tim Couch stood in there under the rush and delivered the football? First down.
That's the best thing he's done today. Very good at taking the hit and delivering the football.
Under the gun now and goes down. Number 59, Roosevelt Colvin, in for the sack along with Philip Daniels.
Colvin, number 59, on the outside. Oh, just a protection problem by the Cleveland Browns. Nobody there to pick him up. Nobody running the short route for Tim Couch to throw the football to.
Colvin with a breather on the sideline. 8 sacks in all for both teams. 5 by the Bears, 3 for the Browns. Jamel White in the lineup now for Cleveland. Couch out of the shotgun. Throws. That's batted into the air. Intercepted, and the Bears are going to win it. Mike Brown has done it again. Robinson appeared to get a hand on the football. And Mike Brown, the hero a week ago, does it on consecutive Sundays, and the Chicago Bears, with a 6-game winning streak, have beaten the Cleveland Browns 27-21.
Brian Robinson tipped that ball so far, it went all the way across the formation for Mike Brown to make the interception.
Courtney Brown, who played a terrific game defensively for the Browns, walked dejectedly off the field. The Chicago Bears scored 20 points in the last 3 minutes and 22 seconds to win it in overtime. Tonight on CBS, coming up next, except on the West Coast, 60 Minutes, followed by the 53rd annual Emmy Awards. For Phil Sims and Armie Katayan, Greg Gumbel, so long from Soldier Field. Our final score, the Bears 27, the Browns 21 in overtime. We'll be sending you to Jim Nantzen Company in New York for the NFL Today. Right after this, you're watching the NFL on CBS.
And now, the Intel Pentium 4 processor highlight of the day. The New England Patriots didn't need miracles today in their win over the Atlanta Falcons, but they did get an immaculate reception. Tom Brady's third touchdown pass found Troy Brown in the right spot. Can't get enough football? Go to NFL.com and create your own highlight reel with Video Mixer. Brought to you by the Intel Pentium 4 processor, the center of your digital world.
And hello, friends, and welcome back to our NFL Today studios. What an amazing
Unbelievable.
Scene. Mike Dick is so fired up. And again, an abridged version of 60 Minutes coming up shortly, then the live broadcast of the Emmy Awards right here on CBS. Come back, not to be believed. Mike Dick, Randy Cross, Jerry Glanville. Down 21-7 with 24 seconds to go in regulation. Two touchdowns, well, the onside kick squeezed in there, the Hail Mary. And Mike Brown, can it happen two straight weeks? Mike, take us through it.
You've got to believe it. Well, here's the Hail Mary. I mean, I'm so happy for Shane Matthews. I mean, this football team believes in itself. They got down today. They made some mistakes. Great catch by James Allen and a touchdown.
Does that look familiar, though, Mike? How does the defensive back not knock that to
exactly.
The...
Hey, my guys did it to me, I know. Watch this play right here.
And
same guy, Mike Brown. And what a great kid he is. Interception for a touchdown. Does this look familiar?
One week ago. In overtime against the
right 49ers. Unbelievable.
Mike Brown back-to-back weeks in overtime, returning intercepted passes for the winning score. And the Bears are now 6-1 on the season. And let's go back out to Soldier Field. Armand Gatayan is with Shane Matthews. Armand.
Like this.
It was bizarre. I tell you, I stunk it up majority of the game. I just played poorly, and our defense hung in there. We made some plays. We hit the Hail Mary, and then we get the onside kick, and you know, it's a dream come true. Then Mike Brown picks it off again and goes the distance. So, you know, we battled till the end. Obviously, we didn't play as well as we liked, but we won, and that's all that matters.
Your thoughts when you let that ball go on the Hail Mary? It looked like a perfect play.
Well, we practiced it a lot. We try to throw it to a guy and let that guy, if he can't catch it, to tip it. And, you know, you really sit in the meeting rooms, you're like, yeah, that's going to work. But, you know, we practice it, and thank goodness it worked today.
You don't practice many things like Mike Brown at the end, though, I imagine.
No, you know, we got a strong defense. They struggled a little bit in the second half, but they came up with a big play when it counted.
Unbelievable game, Shane. Thanks a lot.
All right. Well, David Terrell guaranteed a win, and they get it. The Bears 27-21. How do the Browns handle a loss like this, unlike anything maybe we've ever seen?
I don't think it bothers them. I think this team is mentally tough, and I like what they're doing over there. And when they got beat by the Cincinnati Bengals, they came right back, and I think they'll be back.
All right, guys. Let's take everyone around the league and